For the New York Knicks, the 6 p.m. trading deadline came and passed yesterday with just one minor deal. This is the team, along with new face Terry Cummings, that will carry the Knicks down the stretch. And these are the players who have to get it done. The Knicks have chosen not to shake things up as they prepare for the battles ahead, as Jeff Van Gundy leads them toward a playoff push. The Trailblazers did beat the deadline, acquiring potential free agent Damon Stoudemire. The Portland native at first wasn't so sure he wanted to return home, but he'll be a deadly force for the Blazers for the rest of the season. Was he promised a Rose Garden? The Knicks hope to be a thorn in his side coming up next. From the Rose Garden in Portland, Oregon, it's time for New York Knicks basketball. Tonight, the Knickerbockers visit the Portland Trailblazers. Good evening, everyone. Along with John Andres, I'm Mike Breen. Knicks finish up their three-game West Coast trip. They're 1-1 thus far. And tonight, the newest Knick, he is in town. Terry Cummings arrived in Portland about an hour and a half ago. He was acquired in the trade yesterday from Philadelphia for Herb Williams and Ronnie Grandison. And Cummings flew across the country on the plane all day long in uniform. He'll wear number 35 and is expected to get some minutes tonight for the Knicks in his first game. Of course, the Knicks have not only to welcome their new teammate, they've got to worry about their last outing and try and bounce back from John Wood's perhaps their worst loss of the season, the debacle in Utah against the Jazz.
Yes, as Jeff Van Gundy said, if they play like that, they're not a competitive team. And this is what happens: season lows and points in a game, points in a quarter. Season low first half points, only 30. The Knicks never led. In fact, the Jazz are up by 34 points at one moment.
Jeff Van Gundy was asked, is it an aberration? Do you forget about it, or do you make sure this team learns from all the mistakes in that game?
You don't throw it out, I think, and you don't dwell on it, so it's probably neither one. But you have to learn because, again, we seem to revert back to things that we know won't win for us after we win a couple. And we shot too many long jump shots early, and then for a six-minute part of the second quarter, we totally died defensively. The other three and a half quarters, we were very good defensively. So, you know, we know that won't win for us.
And Van Gundy preparing, of course, for the Blazers and his new man, Terry Cummings. As for Buck Williams, and that's the reason that Cummings is here, because of Buck Williams, he had the knee surgery today. He's already home out of the hospital. The surgery went well and expected to be out 3 to 6 weeks. Now for Portland, they didn't make a minor deal. They made a major deal, and they got a major player. Damon Stoudemire obtained from Toronto. This guy could do wonderful things for this franchise.
Yes, he's been doing it for Toronto. He showed the NBA how tough he is, and he's a major young star in this league, and he's home. This is where it all began for Damon Stoudemire. The penetrating ability makes him very special. He's a pleasure to play with. He's also defensive-minded, a tremendous competitor, and despite his diminutive size, he's tough around the boards. He's an excellent rebounder. But penetration is where it all starts for him, and he is a tremendous player. In only two games now, look at these numbers. He's got double-figure points, assists, rebounds. How about those rebounds in two games? But for the season, the numbers are much bigger, particularly in the assist area. He's one of the league leaders in the important categories. He has a great heart, a competitor, and he's surrounded with young talent that he hopes to make even better.
The Blazers are 1-1 in those two games he's played in. One injury update for Portland: Rasheed Wallace, their fine starting forward, he's out tonight. He's got a hip pointer and he won't play. Starting lineups and opening tip-off as the Knicks finish up their West Coast trip here in the Rose Garden when we return.
Reasons to fly today. Only one that matters to you. At Delta Airlines, it is our pleasure to get you to the place you want to be. Delta Airlines, on top of the world.
The most exciting, long-lasting, most popular car in its class is now very affordable.
Right now, get 2.9% APR GMAC financing or $1,500 cash back on any new 98 Pontiac Grand Am.
Hurry. Grand Am is built to last, but this offer isn't.
See your Tri-State Pontiac dealers.
Flex here to give you a quick hat lesson.
It's all good.
Where you wear it and how you wear it. Nah, man. You got the starter hat.
A Fleshly.
Anything else is the wrong hat. Lesson one. Take the hat with the logo right here. You wear it to the back.
Work it out. Pop.
Lesson two. When you're out with the fam.
Mad conservative.
You wear it gently on top of your head.
My mama don't want me messing up my hairline.
When you
want
to do it New York style.
Sup, boo?
Just go like this. That's the way you wear a starter hat. Don't forget Funkmaster Flex tell you so.
In a premier television event, the Discovery Channel reveals the deadly secret world of espionage. The technology and tactics, the tools of a spy.
You might say I'm dressed to kill.
Spy Tech, premiering Monday at 8 Eastern and Pacific. Only on the Discovery Channel.
The press praised it. Luxury car companies feared it. The public adored it. Now it's about to happen all over again. Presenting the new Nissan Altima. Enjoy the ride.
New York Knicks basketball is brought to you by Brewery Fresh Budweiser, who reminds you fresh beer tastes better. By the American Express card, wherever you are, whatever you are doing, American Express helps you do more. By Hertz, for business, for pleasure, nobody does it exactly like Hertz. And by Citibank, for banking anytime, anywhere, any way you choose. At Citibank, the city never sleeps.
Sergeant First Class William
Please
Smith.
Join us in welcoming tonight's
with a rather stirring edition, John, of tonight's national anthem. Oh,
that was magnificent.
Here at the Rose Garden. Closed captioning brought to you by New York Marriott Marquis, Broadway's biggest hit. And right now, let's get our starting lineups as the Knicks finish up their final game on this three-game road trip. Let's send it over to our public address announcer.
Sitting New York Knicks. Head coach of the Knicks is Jeff Van Gundy. The assistant coaches are Don Chaney, Brendan Malone, Jeff Nix, and Tom Thibodeau. The athletic trainer for the Knicks is Mike Saunders. On the floor for the New York Knicks, starting at forward, number two, Larry Johnson. At forward, number 34, Charles Oakley. At center, number 14, Chris Dudley. At guard, number 20, Allen Houston. At guard, number 21, Charlie Ward. And now, your Blazers. Portland's head coach is Mike Dunleavy. The assistant coaches are Tony Brown, Jim Ion, Bill Musselman, and Elston Turner. The strength and conditioning coach is Bob Medina. The Blazers athletic trainer is Jay Jensen. The equipment manager is Mark Cashman. Now, Are you ready for your Portland Trail Blazers? Fans, you're the sixth man in our house, so let's get loud for our starting five. And here they come, starting at forward, number five, Jermaine O'Neal. At forward, number 44, Brian Grant. Pasetras Nuolietuva, number 11, Arvydas Sabonis. Edgar, number 34, Isaiah J.R. Ryder. And Edgar, number 3, Damon Stoudemire.
Thank you very much, Pete.
High hopes for Damon Stoudemire. Now his third game with the Portland Trail Blazers. Well, the Knicks thought they'd only have to face him one more time because they're only scheduled to play the Raptors one more time. But now, because he's with the Blazers, they have to play him two more times. Not an easy task for Charlie Ward and Chris Childs. Childs knows how difficult Stoudemire can be to defend.
He's a quick player. He caused a lot of problems because of his craftiness with the ball. But he's with a different team now, has more weapons, so it's going to be even more vital to keep him out of the paint because he's going to be looking to get everybody else involved, and especially in transition. So it's not going to be an easy job, but it's not an individual contest defensively. If our mind is right, we're focused, we have a good shot tonight as winning this game.
And Mike Dunleavy said the other day he figures about 10 games before a player really starts to feel comfortable in a new system. Stoudemire not the only player. Walt Williams, a very good player in his own right and have a nice role on this team. And Carlos Rogers also obtained in that deal from Toronto.
Very few players, though, have the privilege of being traded to their hometown. So the comfort level for Stoudemire has to be a lot more than it would be under normal circumstances.
Former Blazer Chris Dudley getting his start. You saw Cummings on the bench. Talk about being uncomfortable. Cummings just meeting his new teammates about an hour and a half ago. And he's been talking. You see now with Tom Thibodeau. Brendan Malone and Jeff Van Gundy briefed him earlier. They did more discussing on how to operate defensively. Got a little bit offensively, but they didn't want to cloud his head. Defense more important right now when you just come on the scene.
Could there be a more perfect selection of someone to fill in for Buck Williams and this guy in every way? As a player, but as a person as well. A solid guy, just like Buck.
And again, Buck Williams, successful surgery. They just got some loose cartilage out of there today. Dr. Norman Scott said it went well. 3 to 6 weeks, he's going to begin rehab immediately. And we're set to go with the Rose Garden. New Holland, Scott Foster, and Bruce Alexander are officials tonight.
The Knicks do not have the luxury, and they know it, to start as they did in Salt Lake City the other night. They have to start strong and stay that way.
Knicks missed their first 7 shots at the Delta Center and fell behind 9-0 here at the Rose Garden. The Blazers have won 6 in a row. Stoudemire puts up the first shot of the night.
Don't think he doesn't remember January 17th. Knicks at Toronto. Charlie Ward outscoring him 18-16. And really, the Knicks really held him in check.
A little full court pressure. Oakley throws it away. Knicks quickly with a turnover. Stoudemire quickly down the court. Ward gets back. That's Jermaine O'Neal, the 19-year-old, going up against Larry Johnson. O'Neal misfired. It's tipped by Grant, but a loose ball foul is going to be called on Brian Grant. Grant getting the start, and he's just coming back from an injury because Rasheed Wallace, as we mentioned, Rasheed Wallace, one of the better young forwards in the league, out with a hip pointer, so Mike Dunleavy doing some switching.
Mike telling me before the game he loves Rasheed Wallace, who's really developing.
Larry Johnson, the feed to Dudley. Chris Dudley, blocked by O'Neal. Johnson right there. The first tip won't go, nor will the second. Stoudemire on the rebound. O'Neal fumbles the pass a bit, but gets it out. Isaiah Ryder. Ball deflected. Johnson tips it to Dudley. Ryder, as Oakley gets it down low, draws the foul, and one.
Charles Oakley with a chance for a three-point play as Sabonis just stares at Hugh Hollins. And Oakley gets the first 2 points of the game on a nice feed from Charlie Ward in the open floor.
Charlie Ward seeing Oakley down the court quickly. Charles Oakley made one of the best moves he's shown around the basket on that play. He made the big man 7'3". Sabonis back up.
Oakley connecting on the free throw. And the Knicks lead it 3-2. Allen Houston on a rider. Kind of a tough week for the two guards defensively. Jeff Hornacek the other day, Ryder tonight. Clyde Drexler coming up on Sunday. No easy passes. Ryder double teamed by Dudley. Three on the shot clock. They get it down low and a slam. Jermaine O'Neal.
2 years ago, he's a high school player in South Carolina. Now he's an NBA player in his second season. He was the youngest guy to ever play in the NBA last season.
Just over 18 years old. Larry Johnson with the fake and the basket.
Very good. Sabonis was very stationary, I'd say, on that play. Sometimes a big guy thinks just because he's there that the other player, if he's a lot smaller, will back down just because of the size difference. But Johnson kept coming.
Knicks lead at 5-4. The pass for Sabonis goes out of bounds. That's the type of thing. You know, where Stoudemire and Sabonis getting a feel, and Dunleavy certainly knows that. You got to know which guy's body language and which way he's leaning. So Stoudemire with the turnover. Larry Johnson gets the feed, the spin, and he draws the foul. Johnson, I don't think, was going to shoot that until he felt the contact on the arm and made the wise adjustment, so he'll shoot two.
See, what made that happen properly for the Knicks is something they've been doing a lot of in their many good games of late, and that is pushing the ball up court, getting the ball into the right hands. In the case of Larry Johnson, he's got to be a major part of the offense for the Knicks to do well, as he has been lately.
And importantly for the Blazers, Sabonis has picked up his second foul. Johnson missing the free throw, so Sabonis will sit down. And rookie Kelvin Cato will come onto the floor. He's their first round pick. A rookie out of Iowa State, actually was selected by the Dallas Mavericks and then traded. An excellent shot blocker. Needs to kind of hone his offensive skills.
Sabonis just strolls off the floor. A guy his size having two quick fouls, probably thinking, it's the NBA. Touch a guy and I'm off the floor now.
Dudley with the pass to Larry Johnson. Excellent play from Chris Dudley. After Johnson missed the two free throws, and the Knicks lead it 7-4. Johnson shaking his head, upset with himself for missing the free throws. Grant posting up Johnson the other end. Grant double team, hoist up the shot. Cato the rebound, quick putback. And the ball knocked out of bounds by O'Neal. Knicks will take it.
See, Grant decided he was going to shoot. He was so well played, he ended up taking a bad shot.
Knicks push it up the floor again. Charles Oakley left wide open. Johnson tries to save it, but throws it out of bounds. And the Blazers will take control. Knicks have come out with a lot of energy and hustle, as we've seen already. Something, as you mentioned, John, was lacking at the Delta Center.
Yes, they're focused initially, no question.
Both teams have played very well since the All-Star break. Blazers 5-1, the Knicks 4-1. Grant, nice little turnaround from the former Sacramento King in his first year with the Blazers.
6'9", 250 plus, and he's solid.
Allen Houston's first shot of the night goes in, and the Knicks lead it 9-6. Good pace early. Knicks looking to push and move the ball quickly. Ryder now will post up Houston. The move across the lane. Dudley the rebound.
Well, this would be a great game for the Knicks to erase the memory of their visit to Utah.
Houston. Oakley wide open again. Misfires. Ryder tips it. Already we've seen the Knicks guards doing more penetration here in the first couple of minutes than they did in the entire first half in Utah. Houston with the deflection. 4-on-2 break now. Knicks have the numbers. Johnson back to Oakley, and he lays it in.
So pretty. So pretty. Everybody moving, exchanging the ball perfectly.
Knicks lead it 11-6. A little over 4 minutes gone by here in the first. Stoudemire the runner. Nice move from Damon Stoudemire. You know, right to the end of that move, you thought he was going to pass. And he still had the perfect shot ready.
That's what's the threat about him. He not only has three-point range, he can penetrate. And excellent distributing at the last second. Well, the total package. Shot clock at 7. Larry Johnson, aggressive move, and he draws another foul. So Johnson will go back to the line. We'll call the foul on Grant, and now Grant has 2 fouls. Remember, the Blazers is a little short-handed without Rasheed Wallace, so Sabonis and Grant each with 2.
Now, Mike, the game's not 5 minutes old. Now, contrast this to 2 nights ago. By this time, the Knicks were probably about, 1 for 8 or 9 from the field in Utah, all jump shots. The personality change so far, so different.
Larry Johnson misses his 3rd straight free throw. And here again, the defense turning into offense, Alan, which the Knicks need.
Houston with the live hands. And that's our AT&T great connection, and it was.
Johnson was 1 of 5 from the line in Utah, and now 0 for 4 tonight. In the game prior to that, in Denver, he was 9 for 9 from the line. So he'd been on a good stretch until the last 2. Knicks still lead it, 11-8. O'Neal poked away by Oakley, but then a foul is called. And they're going to call it against O'Neal. That's right. It looked like Oakley made the clean steal, and then O'Neal held him after Oakley got by him. So the foul on the rookie, 14th foul. Knicks lead 11-8 here on the first.
Gretzky and Housley. Gretzky, nice beat for Sutter. He scores!
You're watching MSG Network.
I'm about to unleash the biblical plague.
For Special Agent Sean Archer.
He wants people dead.
There's only one way to catch a killer.
State-of-the-art morphogenetic template.
You want to take his face and mine?
You've got to become him. From the director of Broken Arrow, John Travolta, Nicolas Cage.
What do you say we trade back?
Face Off.
Plan B. Let's just kill each other.
Playing this month on Direct Ticket, only on Direct TV.
Jazz is freedom of expression with a groove. Our music is the art of improvisation, and that can be analogized to basketball and music. And in basketball, you have your fundamentals, your footwork, the form of your shot. Now, after a while, you know, you start to improvise. So you might be able to make a layup, but then you put a little juke in there. You might throw a no-look pass, or you might go between your legs. It's a wonderful thing.
You're into the game. Get into the gear. Have you heard about Nothing But Hoops? It's the official catalog of the NBA. You can get NBA Authentics. That's the same stuff players wear. Hey, it might even help your game. Get the coolest stuff from any team, anytime, anywhere. Even WNBA stuff. What more could you ask for? For your free Nothing But Hoops catalog, call 1-800-301-4000. That's 1-800-301-4000. I love this stuff.
Remember, when you're having good times with good friends, drink responsibly, because friends know when to say when. A reminder from your friends at Budweiser. 6:57 remaining, first quarter in Portland. Knicks lead 11-8, although Damon Stoudemire already with 2 for 2 from the field.
Game number 3 for Damon here as a member of the Trailblazers.
With a winning team like this, the games and the practices feel so different. You want to be there. In Toronto, sometimes you don't. Such a losing atmosphere right now with the Raptors. You really feel like you've been freed from jail. You know, you get out and the excitement is back. Every night there's excitement. Even in practice, there's excitement, as he said.
He was a high school star here in Portland growing up. His dad's a basketball man. And he's so fortunate at this stage of his career, third season, to be back home.
Oakley with the free throws. And Knicks up by 5-8. Said the Blazers with 14 fouls, but that was their 5th, and courtesy of the Oakley steal. Stoudemire hoists up the shot. This time off the mark. Dudley tips the ball, knocked out of bounds by Oakley. And it's still Blazer ball.
You see, with the amount of big guys and talented people Stoudemire has in front of him, I think it's crazy to throw up a shot like that.
Well, again, it's all part of learning the teammates in Toronto. Perhaps encouraged to do that. Ball knocked loose a couple of times. Grant gets it. Ryder given a second opportunity, quickly hoists it up, and Oakley pulls one down in traffic.
See, that's what can happen. If a guy feels you're not getting the ball, and when he gets it like Ryder did, he's going to fire away, thinking if he doesn't, he may not get more enough chances.
Allen Houston fires away and hits the three-pointer, and the Knicks lead it 16-8. Knick defense very aggressive early. Ryder double team. Gets away from it, but ball knocked loose. Chris Dudley with a good double team. 4-on-2 break. Houston, the wide open three. Dudley, the offensive rebound, put back blocked by O'Neal. Oakley. Charles Oakley nails the jumper, and the Knicks lead it 18-8. A 10-point lead courtesy of a 7-0 run.
Knicks 7 for 14 now from the field.
Grant against Johnson. Dudley the block, but also a piece of the arm. And that's the first foul against the Knicks, and that's why the crowd was a sarcastic cheer. The Blazers, meanwhile, had 5 fouls called on them. Van Gundy talked to him earlier today. Can't wait for the ball to be tossed up tonight. Wanted to get back to action with that Utah game out of the mind as Grant hits the first free throw. Grant signing a big deal with the Blazers after starting off his career, his first 3 years with Sacramento. But he's been banged up this year with a leg injury, just returned the last couple of weeks after being injured for a while, missed 18 games.
You know, you talk about the Knicks wanting to erase that Utah experience. I was thinking, Mike, you know, Utah had a game recently against the Clippers in L.A. where they lost to the Clippers, which was a disgrace. The next night, they go out and beat Chicago.
Yep. There are certain nights where just nothing is happening. That was one for the Knicks. Allen Houston with 7 points early on. The Knicks lead it 20-10. So Houston, who had a poor shooting night against Utah, has rebounded nicely thus far. He's 3 for 4. Shot clock down to 8. Nice feed to Stoudemire, and Stoudemire with Dudley on top of him, able to get it in.
Makes it look easy, but there's a lot of talent wrapped up in that little body. How he got that shot up and in is amazing.
5'11". That's stretching it. He's more like 5'9", 5'10", perhaps. Charles Oakley with the quick release. And Oakley, it's his second consecutive jumper. 9, check that, 11 points for Charles Oakley. Knicks lead it by 10. Just under 4.5 remaining in the first. Oakley dives, nearly forces another turnover. Grant, Dudley lost it. Ball knocked loose out of bounds, and it's Blazer ball. Walt Williams will check in for the first time as Jermaine O'Neal will sit down. Williams, the other player obtained along with Carlos Rogers.
Get the sense early that the Knicks' quick start has taken a lot of the starch out of this young Portland team.
Ryder misfires. Dudley gets his 5th rebound here in the first quarter. And Charlie Ward ball for carry.
Trailblazers need Stoudemire to really start distributing the ball and getting the other guys into the action. He can't go his way now and try and do this by himself.
This is the second Knick turnover.
Which is what which is what he's used to doing with Toronto.
The short jumper from Cato. Again, not known for his offensive prowess, more of a shot blocker and a rebounder. Cato makes it 22-14. Just under 3.5 remaining opening quarter.
Knicks not looking for the quick jump shot.
Houston on the fake, gets Ryder in the air and puts it in. Allen Houston now with 9 points. And the Knicks lead back to 10. Knicks shooting 59% from the field. Blazers at 37%.
Houston and Oakley together combined for 20 points here. 9 minutes into the game.
Knicks getting good shots, unlike the other night in Utah. Walt Williams quickly puts up his first shot way off the mark. Cato the rebound. Ryder. Ryder's not going to miss a lot of open jumpers.
Ryder's been on a tear lately, last six games, 25 a game.
He was due for one. He had missed his first five from the field. And the Knicks will call timeout. 2:39 remaining, first quarter in Portland. Knicks shooting 59%, have an 8-point lead.
Let's start with the brewmaster for just a moment. The brewmaster is the chef. And that is the key brewmaster role, to understand the blending of his or her ingredients. Not only he or she tastes the beer every day, there's another person who tastes the beer every day, and that is me. The ability to have hands-on brewmasters working with the finest ingredients gives you Budweiser.
When Olga Maslova wants to phone her husband, she gives new meaning to the words long-distance call. He works in a space station.
Before you call or you fax or you internet, you need this, 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 and this.
It's a job for Siemens. We're experts in voice, data, video, all kinds of communications, anywhere on Earth. So why not above the Earth as well?
So for this, 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 or this, or this.
We're Siemens.
We can do that.
The Infiniti i30 and Lexus ES300 offer luxury, comfort, and performance. The i30 also offers a power sunroof, leather-appointed interior, custom Bose audio system, and the i30 is priced $3,300 less than a comparably equipped ES300, and they make you pay for the floor mats. Lease the Infiniti i30 for $399 a month for 39 months with an initial payment of $1,249. Infiniti. Own one, and you'll understand.
2:39 remaining, first quarter in Portland. Knicks lead at 24-16. Blazers sputtering a little bit offensively. One of the reasons, as John, you pointed out, Damon Stoudemire looking for a shot bit, not getting his teammates involved as much, perhaps, as he should. And Mike Dunleavy knows that that is still the primary goal for Stoudemire and his point guards.
I think it's very positive because your point guard is basically your leader, the extension of the coach on the floor, and his ability, momentum-wise, to erase mistakes, because you know he's out there. He can, if there is a mistake, he can push the ball and create and get easy opportunities for other players. I think, you know, he makes other plays for other people. It makes them better.
Stoudemire 6 points, does not have an assist yet. Allen Houston, little head fake, Ryder way up in the air, and Houston misses. Cato had it, lost it, ball knocked loose. Stoudemire picks it up. Chris Mills is checked in for the Knicks for the first time. Ryder given a 3-pointer. He's now 1 of 7 from the field, trying to save it, but he was out of bounds. Knicks will take it.
That's what makes a player unpopular with his teammates and the fans. Come over half court, one pass, bombs away. That was Ryder.
He's been unpopular here recently. Ryder in a recent game was taken out by Mike Dunleavy, was upset, left the building before the game was over. Just left his team. Took a lot of heat for that and made some inflammatory comments as Allen Houston goes nicely to the hole. Houston now with 11 points. Knicks lead it 26-16.
I asked Mike Dunleavy about that, Mike, before the game, and he said he took him out because he was taking some bad shots. Didn't chastise him or anything. But the fans turned on Ryder, and that's what made him upset. So then he left, and then, of course, leaving the floor during the game resulted in a one-game suspension. This is a 5 games ago.
So Grant hit that. Ryder today called the fans inconsistent. They've been booing him on every introduction. He was booed when he was introduced today. There were some cheers, but his first game back since that incident is a jumper is good from Chris Mills. He was booed every time he touched the ball.
Imagine a player calling the fans inconsistent.
But he's had his run-ins
with ridiculous.
Run-ins with the law. He's been late for practices. And he's had an awful lot of problems that he's brought on himself. As he fires a three,
that's now 1 of 8. He's pretty inconsistent too, isn't he, tonight?
Well, he's actually been pretty consistent. He's missing everything.
Right.
As the Knicks will get it back. John Starks will check in for the first time. And Allen Houston will sit down. Houston, 5 of 7, 11 points in 11 minutes. We're just shy of 11 minutes as there's 1:07 remaining. Knicks off to a good start. The exact opposite of what happened in Utah. Oakley the lob, the poor decision. Starks are able to track it down, however. Mills quickly his second shot. Chris Mills in and out. That one halfway down. Dudley lost it. Stoudemire, beautiful adjustment to get away from Ward. And the pass to Ryder. The whistle. And a blocking foul called on Chris Mills.
Well, Stoudemire made everybody happy with that play. The fans really came to life. Charlie Ward couldn't quite get his hands on that ball. Stoudemire then pushed it up court, and Ryder, as you can see, Mills lean into him, draws the foul.
Ryder hitting the free throw. Ryder, by the way, one of the reasons he's booed, not just because he left the game, but I mentioned inflammatory comments. He basically called the city a racist city, or said there was a lot of racism here. He later apologized for it, but the damage really has been done. However, as he hits the second one, according to Peter Vesey in today's New York Post, Blazers had a chance to trade Ryder to L.A. for Brent Barry, but Dunleavy said no, that he wanted to keep Ryder and feels that he can make it work. So confidence from the coach.
Well, Mike recognizes his considerable skills and is willing to live with the personality.
3 second violation results in the third Knick turnover. 28-20, Knicks lead by 8. Half minute remaining here in the opening quarter. There's about a 2.5 second differential, actually closer to 3 between the shot clock and game clock. Shot clock down to 6. Stoudemire. Cato kicks it out. Williams has to hoist it up and puts it in, a 3-pointer. That was just a heave. 3.6 seconds remaining. Starks has plenty of time, drives down the lane, but it won't go. There's a lot of contact. Williams wants an offensive foul. Van Gundy can't believe no foul was called on Williams. But an exciting first quarter comes to an end. And Alexander just told Van Gundy, hey, if anything, he pushed off. So the first quarter complete here in Portland. The Knicks leading 28-23, a 5-point lead, as it ends on a very physical play.
The most exciting, long-lasting, most popular car in its class is now very affordable.
Right now, get 2.9% APR GMAC financing or $1,500 cash back on any new 98 Pontiac Grand Am.
Hurry, Grand Am is built to last. But this offer isn't.
See your Tri-State Pontiac dealers.
So? We have to let more folks know about us.
Dad, we need a new location.
Every man has a place.
Now check this out.
Dad.
There's a space.
See?
This is our new location.
This is the internet.
Whoa.
475 people visited our gallery on our website last night.
I told you, location is everything.
Experience the art of doing business on the internet with the most powerful network in the world.
With the Nissan Maxima's powerful V6, Ward's Auto World called it one of the 10 best engines of 98. And with standard features like air conditioning, power locks and windows, and comfortable seating for 5, IntelliChoice called it a best overall value in its class. Take advantage of this limited time offer, and you can call the Maxima the best thing of all, yours. Right now, get the Nissan Maxima with $1,500 cash back and 5.9% APR for up to 60 months. Ends March 2nd.
It's another College Hoops doubleheader. LIU visits Monmouth in a Northeast matchup, followed by Xavier at Duquesne in an A-10 battle. Saturday on MSG.
New York Knicks basketball is brought to you in part by the 68,000 professionals at Delta Airlines. By American Express. Wherever you are, whatever you are doing, American Express helps you do more. And by New York Life. Integrity, humanity, and strength are what make New York Life the company you keep.
Attention all young sports fans. Saturday morning at 10 on the MSG Network, Starter presents Play It Up. And this week, it features Knicks forward Chris Mills and Chris Dudley.
I come across the pick and roll. Chris Dudley rolls to the basket. I can find him for the finish. Usually one of my favorites coming off this pick and roll here is to get around the guy and, of course, shoot the ball. When I'm about this close to the basket, I try to use the backboard.
Play It Up Saturday at 10 on the MSG Network. Knicks turn it over. Stoudemire racing down against Childs, who's checked in. The feed to Walt Williams, draws the foul. Chris Mills at the wrong place at the wrong time, picks up his second. And free throws coming up for Walt Williams.
John
sat with four turnovers.
Starks went up in the air, not quite sure what he was doing with the ball, and then threw it into the hands of Stoudemire. And he pushes it up, so the Trailblazers get an opportunity to score at the foul line now. So much has been made of the trade featuring Stoudemire, but the man who's at the foul line, as we talked at the open, Mike, a very, very important asset for this franchise.
He was a lottery pick back in 92, seventh overall selection by Sacramento. It's now his sixth year in the league. And Portland is fourth NBA team. Sacramento, Miami for a brief stint, Toronto. And now the Blazers, as he hits the two free throws. He can score. He averaged 1 year, 17 a game. Nick lead cut to three. Mills tied up, ball knocked away, and they call it Blazer ball. Stacey Augman, good double team. Mills felt he got hacked there. Has words with Scott Foster.
Sabonis back in the lineup now. He was part of the reason Mills got in trouble. He takes away all the vision when he's around you with his 7'3" frame. The guy's huge.
His basketball instincts are amazing. He's one of the smarter players on the floor.
Well, we'll see before this game is over, assuming he stays out of foul trouble, his passing ability.
Oakley blocked it, but also got a piece of the arm, and Sabonis will shoot two. Oakley picking up his first foul. Dudley will come back in. And Sabonis to the line. Sabonis, 33 years old. This is only his third year. Of course, was the best player in Europe throughout most of the 1980s. He's well past his prime as Dudley returns. He's a shell of himself in terms of physically. He had all these ruptured Achilles problems. But he still has such great basketball skills. And this year he's playing more minutes than he's had in the previous two and really playing well.
He's an original draft choice of Portland and going back to 1986. But between then and 3 years ago, he became a legend in Europe.
Nick lead cut to one. Childs looking. And a travel called on Chris Childs. Kind of an interesting call. Nobody guarding him away from the basket. Jeff Van Gundy looking a little puzzled on that call. Six turnovers now for the Knicks. Stacey Augman, Walt Williams, Stoudemire, Cato, and Sabonis now in for the Blazers. And a double foul has been called. It goes against Stoudemire and Childs. Childs picks up his first, same for Stoudemire. So that results in just the Blazers taking the ball out of bounds. If you look in the paint, you'll see the two of them going at it.
They certainly did.
Sabonis against his former practice center. Hook shot won't get in. Boy, it's just fun to see a hook shot. Cato the rebound. Stoudemire misfires. And look at Mills fight Dudley for that rebound. Chris Mills is doing an excellent job on the boards recent weeks. Childs, nice move to the basket. Knicks lead by three.
Blazers do not get enough defensive intimidation or presence by Sabonis. Perhaps he's holding back now with two fouls.
Stoudemire, the penetration short pull-up.
You know, it's amazing how physical Stoudemire is. One of the coaches was telling me how impressed he is with his ability to set picks at his size. Who would think of a man that size being noted for his picks?
5'10", 171 pounds. Starks misses. Chris Mills the rebound. Try to get it to Dudley. Knicks will set it up again. 1 point lead for the Knicks. Just over 2 minutes gone by. Second quarter in Portland. Giles the drive. Throws it away. Knicks starting to turn the ball over a lot. Stoudemire knocks it down, and the Blazers back in front by one. David Stoudemire, 10 points. Jeff Van Gundy wants a 20-second timeout. And a nice ovation here. Many of the fans of the Rose Garden on their feet. As the Blazers bouncing back from a 10-point first quarter deficit to take a 1-point lead.
Well, here's a look at the super skills of Stoudemire. Look at him going into all those defenders and getting that shot up without a hand in his face. Stoudemire just pushing it right in, makes the defense back up. You talk about nice hand, Mike. You know what I couldn't help but note when the Knicks were introduced before the game, Larry Johnson course, the other Knicks, the cheering for the Knicks, it was noteworthy. You know, you don't find that on the visiting court very often.
Well, we've seen on this road trip in all three cities a lot of Knicks fans. As the Knicks wrap up the West Coast trip and then return home and our Delta Airlines schedule. Sunday afternoon against Houston, NBC TV will have it. And then two more home games against Golden State Tuesday and Thursday against the Milwaukee Bucks. So a three-game homestand coming up for the Knicks.
Every game so important for the Knicks.
Starks way off the mark. Childs the rebound. But the shot clock did not reset, which is now down to 8. Mills, tough shot. Augman makes a bad decision, but able to get it to his teammate.
See how Williams contested that shot of Mills, took his vision away.
Knicks down by 1. Since the Knicks led 28-18, you see the turnovers in the second quarter. Blazers have scored 13 of the last 15 points of this one. Stacey Augman, the Sabonis can't handle a pass, but Johnson tips it to Stoudemire. 2 on the shot clock. Almost goes in. That was almost a terrific shot as Starks grabs the rebound. Mills with the drive, blocked. Dudley right there for the follow. Jeff Van Gundy furious. No foul was called on the Mills shot. Mills can't believe it. There was a lot of contact.
Knicks really geared up to guard against the skills of Stoudemire. Whenever he makes a move around his man, there's another Knick right there. The idea, get the ball out of his hands.
Rick Brunson, a rookie from Temple, comes in as Stoudemire sits down. John Crotty, their main backup point guard, is on the injured list now. And Brunson, who spent some time in Knick camp.
He's had some very good moments since the All-Star game.
32-31, Knicks lead by 1. Mills gets knocked down setting a screen. Starks with the jumper. John Starks way off the mark. He's 0 for 4. Three of them have not even been close. Cato on the fall away. There's some horrible shooting here. And Starks gets the rebound. 32-31. Knicks by 1. Larry Johnson the jumper. And Johnson hits his third field goal. 6 points, 3 rebounds for Johnson.
Knicks got to play with Larry Johnson a little bit more. Sabonis trying to get that low position. Dudley really banging hard.
Cato trying to get the baseline. Now for Cato. Kelvin Cato now, 4 points, 4 rebounds, and a blocked shot. Mills. Dudley, another offensive rebound. He's got 7 total boards. Childs, 3 won't go. Dudley tips it to Johnson. Johnson is fouled, shot won't go, and he'll get 2 more free throws. But Chris Dudley all over the boards. And Johnson will go to the line for 2. 6:48 remaining, second quarter. A 1-point Knick lead.
The Knicks are at the Garden to battle the Warriors after MCS Cannon game night, Tuesday night on MSG.
So what do you think? What do you think of the gear? Do you like the stuff?
I like the gear, man.
This makes me feel great. I mean, look at this stuff. Look at the waistband here.
Sweet, man. It's really nice. I like it.
People get up in the morning and they put on their clothes. They put on the best suit they can to go to work because it makes them feel good. So on the basketball court, you know, when you're wearing the best clothes, you feel good and your confidence, it goes another level.
Yeah!
NBA Authentic Gear redesigned by Champion, Starter, and Nike. Get your NBA gear at the Sports Authority.
We work for a highly funded yet unofficial government agency. Our mission is to monitor extraterrestrial activity on Earth.
Oh, that can't be good.
I knew it. This is an alien, and you guys are from some government agency trying to keep it under wraps.
No.
Men in Black.
Playing this month on Direct Ticket, only on Direct TV.
Come along, join the
the biggest stars as they soar into the night.
We hit the stage to watch the NBA play. All the pros proclaim, I love this game.
I love this game.
I love this game.
As we mentioned earlier, the Knicks happy with Buck Williams, the surgery successful today on the knee. They're also very happy with the progress of Patrick Ewing since the cast came off and the mobility in the wrists. And even when the cast was on, as you see Ewing with Greg Brittenham, the strength and conditioning coach, continues to work himself into terrific shape. According to Brittenham, Ewing's in as good shape as he's been in a long time. This is a scene you can see almost every day, either running like this or on the treadmill. He's been working extra hard. Stay in proper shape.
You know, with all the trades, Mike, of the last week, I'm sure fans are thinking, why did the Knicks do this? Why didn't they do that? And the fact of the matter is, as Ernie Grunfeld so recently made clear, he said the right opportunity didn't present itself. They didn't want to make a lateral move. And there's the recent answer to the Buck Williams situation. Terry Cummings just flying out here all day to get here, and he'll fly back tomorrow morning to New York. But as Ernie went on to say, the team was put together with Patrick Ewing in the mix, and he'll be back, and they didn't want to weaken themselves just to put a Band-Aid in this situation. That's why nothing dramatic took place.
Well, Knicks, of course, were built to try and make a run for a championship with Patrick Ewing. And we'll try it next year when Ewing returns, as Johnson misses his first four free throws. It's those two. Knicks back up by three. 8 points for Larry Johnson. Ryder, who's one of eight from the field. Sabonis against Dudley. You don't see a lot of those, but Sabonis with a nice hook shot.
Well, any fans who like the hook shot, take a good look, because this is the man who can do it. And at 7'3", there's an advertisement for a hook shot. How the heck do you block that when the guy turns with his shoulder into you?
Knicks lead by one. Childs, the penetration got knocked out of his hands, and now they're going to overrule it. Bruce Alexander called a travel initially, did not see the deflection. The ball was deflected out of Childs' hands. That's why he traveled with it. Let's take a look. You see Sabonis got a piece of it, and Hollins overrules the call. Mike Dunleavy wants an answer. He's complaining about a substitution. Knicks substituted Allen Houston in the game during that stoppage, and he feels they shouldn't allow that. They're going to take Houston out of the game.
Well, Chris Childs won that battle.
Cannot sub on a violation, so Houston will go sit down. They buzzed them in. Dunleavy gave a kind of a dirty look to the scorer's table. Knicks will get it back. Only six on the shot clock, however. Childs has it knocked, gets it back. Dudley with a little jump hook of his own. Chris Dudley, 4 points, seven rebounds.
Hey, he knows the baskets around here. Spent 4 years here.
We mentioned him and Sabonis. Used to battle and practice all the time. Knicks lead by three, 5:45 remaining in the second. Stacey Augmon, offensive foul. Augmon pushed off as Dudley came in to help out on defense. Another strong play from Dudley.
You know, Mike, one of the great things the Knicks are doing defensively is keeping Sabonis out of the flow here. They can't even run their offense through him the way Dudley's been tying him up and taking him away as a target. When I say running the offense through him, I mean getting him the ball so he can pass. He's a great passer, and he's just not involved.
He's only taken two shots. Houston against Ryder. Allen Houston, that's a two. In and out, and in again. Allen Houston now with 13 points, and the Knicks back up by five. Six of eight shooting for Houston. Ryder. An illegal defense called against the Knicks there first, so warning. John Starks the culprit. Blazers will take it out of bounds.
Knicks going with the small lineup now. That's what's kept Charles Oakley on the bench. Charles, who started out magnificently, 4 of 8 for the game in 13 minutes thus far. Also has a couple of assists.
Timeout. Blazers. Ball's a 20-second timeout.
with 5:09 remaining. Well, Dunleavy knows got his work cut out for him to integrate Stoudemire, Williams, and Rogers. Of course, Kenny Anderson was here for a number of years. They also lost Alvin Williams, an impressive rookie from Villanova, and Gary Trent, who was a good player but was having some off-the-court problems. Now, interesting comment I picked up before the game about Kenny Anderson, who's due to be here with the Celtics, his new team, on Sunday, and reports are that he will not be playing. And there were some references by the coaching staff of Portland to the fact that they felt he wasn't in that good a shape. Isn't that amazing? And particularly to play the Patino-type basketball, perhaps. They don't. Maybe Rick doesn't want to put him out there, yeah, and play the, you know, have him play the style of Celtics play with all that pressure and not have him be at his best.
You see Portland there in the Western Conference standings as Dudley rejects Ryder. Ball knocked out of bounds, and it's going to be Nick Ball. Boy, Chris Dudley is playing a very strong defensive game. He's got 2 block shots and 7 rebounds.
Well, he's very well liked here. His style of play is in line with the people of Portland and how they present themselves, hardworking, real basic player. And that's what Chris is.
Johnson against O'Neal. Larry Johnson. Rebound Brunson. Brunson and Stoudemire in there at the same time, along with Ryder. Small lineup. Knicks also with the 3 guards, with Childs, Starks, and Houston. Starks poking it out of bounds. 13 left on the shot clock. Ryder, the leaner. Dudley tips it. Sabonis, the rebound in traffic. He's fouled and 1. Vitas Sabonis with the strong move and a chance for a 3-point play.
Well, the man is so huge. You see him get the inside position here now. Second effort gets him the ball. Then he just chooses the way he wants to put it in the basket. He comes off a 13.6 out of 11 game against Seattle, which broke their winning streak, their 5-game winning streak the other night at Seattle. Prior to that, though, it was 5 straight wins. Houston and the Lakers were 2 of the teams that fell to the Trailblazers of late.
Blazers are 3-0 against the Utah Jazz this year.
And you know what, Mike, that you bring it up? They outshot them in 3 games, and they out-rebounded them in those 3 games. I was looking at those box scores today. That says a lot after fans might have seen that Utah performance the other night.
Allen Houston misfires. Dudley, by the way, that last foul, his second. So Terry Cummings is off the bench. And Knicks call for another illegal defense. Their second, so a technical foul. And the veteran, number 35, Terry Cummings, enters the game. 36 years old in his 16th year out of DePaul. Ryder will shoot the technical. The Knicks are his 6th NBA team. Ryder able to put it in. Cummings has played for the San Diego Clippers, who drafted him back in 82. Milwaukee a couple of times. San Antonio, Seattle, Philadelphia. 17.2 for his career. 7 different seasons he averaged over 20 points per game. Was a big-time scorer, but knows now that's not his role. Sabonis draws the foul. Cummings lost him and tried to grab him. And Arvydas Sabonis now starting to make his presence felt.
Well, Sabonis with Terry Cummings riding him just takes Terry's weight and uses it to spring off to the drive along the baseline to draw the foul.
Sabonis, as you mentioned, 7'3". They list him at 292. Oakley will come back in. Sabonis is a good free throw shooter. 77% for his career. Starks will sit down. Blazers 11 of 11 from the free throw line. Sabonis hit all 4 of his. Blazers back up by 1. A 6-0 run now for Portland. Knicks trail at 41-40, just under 4 minutes remaining, second quarter. And a whistle away from the ball. As goes against Portland. Brunson commits his first. Only the second team foul. Brunson needs a haircut, John. Either that or he needs a comb it. Well, a disheveled.
I think a lot of people are very envious, though, of that full head of hair.
Larry Johnson. Childs. There's the penetration and dish. Charles Oakley completes it. Charles Oakley, 13 points on 5 of 7 shooting. And the Knicks back up by one.
Amazing, after all that time sitting, Charles comes out and still has the touch. He didn't cool down.
And another illegal defense, third against the Knicks. They argue the call. Receive encouragement from their coach. Another technical foul, so Ryder will shoot it. Ryder is 1 of 10 from the field, but he's perfect from the line in 3 attempts. Blazers remain perfect as a team. They're 13 for 13. 3:16 remaining. Brian Grant comes back in. Brunson sits down. Game tied at 42. Knicks led by 10 in the first quarter. Came out red hot shooting, nearly 60% in the first couple of minutes. Sabonis. Ryder, tough fall-away shot.
That suggests Michael Jordan. He goes up for the shot, and his man is on him, and then he fades away, and he becomes impossible to bother.
Timeout, Knicks. 2:53 remaining second quarter. Ryder just 2 of 11. But he gives the Blazers a 44-42 lead here in Portland.
American Express Small Business Services. How can I help you?
How can I help you?
Right. We only work with small businesses.
Why don't we start with your cash flow?
And our equipment financing plan will help spread out the payments.
That'll definitely give you more flexibility.
How about setting up a line of credit?
We can do that.
Then I'll put you in touch with one of our CPAs so you can start getting ready for tax time.
We can always make adjustments when your situation changes.
Call 1-800-SUCCESS to find out how American Express Small Business Services can help you do more.
If you've been getting those phone stickers, you may be getting a little confused. So allow me to simplify.
I love stickers.
Okay, but if you're calling anywhere in America or anywhere around the world, most calls from home will cost you less with AT&T One Rate and One Rate International.
So you're saying the sticker...
I'm saying if you use those stickers, you could get a little sticky. You might get stuck paying more with those stickers.
Yeah, I know, I got that. But I love stickers.
Never been more frightened in my life.
In America and around the world, the AT&T One Rate plans.
The Infiniti i30 and Lexus ES300 offer luxury, comfort, and performance. The i30 also offers a power sunroof, leather-appointed interior, custom Bose audio system, and the i30 is priced $3,300 less than a comparably equipped ES300, and they make you pay for the floor mats. Lease the Infiniti i30 for $399 a month for 39 months with an initial payment of $1,249. Infiniti. Own one, and you'll understand.
Bill Daughtry back in New York with a sports desk update. Closing seconds at the arena. Watch the Indiana Pacers work the ball. Jackson to Mullen, back to Jackson. Mark drives, swings it out to Reggie Miller. Closing seconds. Reggie misses the three-point try. Orlando hangs on for the 93-91 win. Nick Anderson with 37. Let's go back to Portland.
Thank you, Bill. Well, they're growing big up here in Portland.
A couple of soldiers out here during the timeout, amusing everybody. They're about 13 feet tall.
Childs misses the three as Ryder gets the rebound. A little stiff. Not a lot of mobility.
I think there was a normal body, though, in some of those outfits.
And a whistle away from the ball. Chris Childs call for a hold. And the Knicks now, for Childs, that's his second already. And the Knicks over the limit. Knicks sending the Blazers to the line quite a bit, whether it be for fouling here in the second or the illegal defenses. Early on, they had not committed a foul for quite some time in the first quarter, but they're certainly making up for it here in the second. So Grant will go there. Blazers perfect from the line. Knicks continue to struggle. They're 5 of 9 tonight. The other night in the loss against the Utah Jazz, Knicks were 11 of 23, 48%. Charlie Ward set to check back in.
As we mentioned earlier, Grant.
Now Stoudemire, excuse me, John, he's going to shoot the free throws.
Yeah, we thought it was going to be Grant.
Too far. Plus the penalty.
Knicks did a great job on Stoudemire. January 17th, held him to 16 points in Toronto. Charlie Ward had the game of his life. Boy, 7 of 8 from the field, 4 three-point shots.
That's the first miss from the line as Ward comes back in. Childs will sit down. First miss of the line from the Trailblazers. Remember, Stoudemire will be a free agent after this season. Has not emphatically said he'll re-sign. He says, I'll think about the re-signing long and hard. His team has a great nucleus of young players. But he's going to ask, like, for $90 million. That's what they expect.
He's going to be able to eat and clothe himself, Mike. You can be assured of that.
Yeah. The lead now, Portland's largest here in the first half. Houston, pretty feed, but Oakley can't handle it. Ball knocked out of bounds. Last touch by Sabonis. They're going to say it's Portland ball. They checked. The official under the basket, Bruce Alexander, didn't see. He checked with Scott Foster, who said, let's jump it up. But then New Hollins came from outside and said, no. Knicks touch it last. I think he was right.
Oddly enough, he was the furthest away, too.
Stoudemire, the penetration blocked from behind. Ball tipped out again. Jermaine O'Neal will hand it to Ryder.
Larry Johnson has rendered O'Neal quiet.
Under 2 minutes remaining here in the first half. Sabonis, Ryder, that hop step. Oakley the rebound. Fires a pass ahead to Houston, 3-on-1 break. Houston to Cummings. Harry Cummings has to track it down. Cummings getting his first action as a Knick. Cummings and Sabonis going at it pretty hard. Larry Johnson to Cummings, and a travel. Knicks turn it over for the ninth time here in the first half. 1:31 remaining here in the second, along with John Andres, Mike Breen on hand at the Rose Garden in Portland, where the Trailblazers have won 6 in a row. They've lost 10 games overall at home. O'Neal to Ryder. Stoudemire, that's a three. Allen Houston grabs the rebound. Houston loses it on an attempted drive. Make a 10 turnover. Stoudemire back pass to Grant. Offensive foul. Charlie Ward, who drew 3 charges in Denver the other night, able to draw the charge here.
Charlie
Grant
Ward
picks up his third.
He did the best he could possibly do on that play because it was all Trailblazers. Charlie Ward just outside that restricted area to draw the foul, and he knew exactly where he was.
Grant will sit down with the 3 fouls.
As a secondary defender, which Charlie was on that play, if you're in that restricted area, you cannot succeed in drawing the offensive foul.
Houston with a quick jump shot. Allen Houston now with 15 points. Knicks trail by 1. 7 of 10 from the field. Knicks is a team shooting just under 49%. Blazers are winning despite shooting 40%. Stoudemire foul as he goes to the glass, and he'll shoot 2. Coming up at halftime, we'll have the Tri-State Jeep and Eagle halftime report. There's only 1 Jeep, and it's only at your Tri-State Jeep and Eagle dealer. Bill Daughtry will be back at the MSG Sports Desk. And then John and I will have first half highlights. Back here in Portland. Stoudemire here in the first half. 8 points, 2 assists, 2 rebounds. Check that, 11 points for Stoudemire. He has 4 rebounds.
I would think Mike Dunleavy isn't pleased with the amount of long-range jump shooting his team is shooting here in the first half. I mean, when they don't get something after the first or second pass, they're letting them go from long range. They got so many big guys up front that they're just not working with.
I'm leaving his first season as Cummings sits down. Stoudemire with another. He misses another. So Stoudemire has the only 2 misses. The rest of the team is at 13 for 13. Knicks trail by 2. Here's your time remaining in the first half. Starks falls down as he's tripped up. An inadvertent trip by Stacey Augman, but a trip nonetheless. Only the 3rd team foul, so the Knicks will take it out of bounds. First team foul the last 2 minutes. So the next foul would be a shooting foul.
This is the first game Augman has played in 3 games.
former college teammate of Larry Johnson. Those two chatted before the game. Shot clock is turned off. Knicks will hold it for the final shot here in the first half. Starks against Ogden, who's a terrific defender. Starks fires three-pointer. Off the mark, O'Neal the rebound. They won't get a shot off in time. Stoudemire flips it up after the buzzer. And that will end the first half. Knicks led by 10 in the first quarter. Shot the ball extremely well in the first 12 minutes. But in the second quarter, turned it over seven times. As Jeff Van Gundy, obviously not happy with that shot from John Starks, who's 0 for 5 from the field here in the first half. But Allen Houston with 15 points, Charles Oakley with 13. However, the Knicks trail by 2. Final game of this three-game West Coast trip. We'll be back after this timeout.
We got the motion, got the mix. MSG and the New York Knicks. MSG and the New York Knicks. MSG and the New York Knicks.
Jazz is freedom of expression with a groove. Our music is the art of improvisation, and that can be analogized to basketball and music. And in basketball, you have your fundamentals, your footwork, the form of your shot. Now, after a while, you know, you start to improvise. So you might be able to make a layup, but then you put a little juke in there. You might throw a no-look pass, or you might go between your legs. It's a wonderful thing.
For Annie, it was the right place.
Who's ready to partay on the big boat beside me?
With the right guy.
This almost seems too perfect, doesn't it?
At exactly the wrong time. Again.
Oh, man! A position charges throughout the ship.
I've been in worse situations than this, and panicking does not help. Trust me.
How are you going to stop me now, my friend?
This will do.
Speed 2 Cruise Control.
I am never leaving the house again.
Playing this month on Direct Ticket, only on Direct TV.
Today's flight is a special one.
Meet the first class passenger.
Makes the Manson family look like the Partridge family.
Of Con Air.
Where are you going with my plane?
We're going to Disneyland.
Now, it may be their party.
Yeehaw!
But someone.
He's a U.S. Ranger, highly decorated.
Is about to crash it. From Jerry Bruckheimer, producer of The Rock.
It's on your mind, hillbilly.
Goodbye.
Con Air.
Buckle up.
Playing this month on Direct Ticket, only on Direct TV.
More than great dunks, more than great D. It's Shaquille O'Neal's new video, Shaq Around the World. It's an all-access look that gives you Shaq's amazing NBA highlights and personal insight. You'll see Shaq thrill fans around the world with his awesome power and skills on the court while he continues to dedicate himself to winning an NBA championship. Shaq Around the World is available in stores now through NBA.com or by calling 1-800-NBA-HOOPS from NBA Video.
The telecast of the National Basketball Association may not be retransmitted, reproduced, or rebroadcast without the express written consent of the NBA.
Halftime in Portland, and the Knicks trailing the Trailblazers 46-44. You're watching the Tri-State Chief and Eagle Halftime Report, maker of the most award-winning brand of 4x4s on Earth. Knicks trying to wrap up this road trip with a win. They're 1-1 thus far in the three games. We'll have more here from the Rose Garden, but first to New York and Bill Daughtry.
Thank you very much, Mike Green. Of course, the New Jersey Nets, they were in action tonight. Too much Sean Kemp over at the Meadowlands Arena. Cleveland with the victory tonight. Kemp had the big night, 109-95. Cleveland over the New Jersey Nets. The highlights, you see Mike Fratello trying to figure out how to break a three-game losing streak. Well, his team gets it together, but it was Sean Kemp, 27 points, 13 rebounds, 8 assists on the night. Had quite a game against New Jersey. Sam Cassell here making a move to the iron. He scored. Cassell with 28. 8 points, Nets up by 2 at the half. Third quarter, Brevin Knight feeds Ilgauskas, Zydrunas Ilgauskas with the slam, 71-65 Cleveland. Later in the third quarter, rookie Cedric Henderson. He had a good game against the Knicks, had a career high tonight of 27 with the nice baseline drive in the lane. 83-72 Cavaliers. John Calipari just shaking his head, 109-95. The lost Nets home winning streak stopped at 4 games. Ronnie Cicely, he has reported to New Jersey, won't be active for a while. Ronnie with a halftime news conference telling the world he's happy to be in New Jersey.
Well, I hope this is my last stop. I'm going to try to make this my last stop. I want to play here as many years as I can. I feel this is like an up-and-coming team. This is the team of the future. I can't see why we can't be a team like the Utah Jazz, who are going to contend for the next 6-7 years. So if I'm here, I'll play hard and I'll do whatever I can to make the best of it, and hopefully we can get ourselves a championship here.
Veteran NBA referee Mike Mathis resigned from the league today after pleading guilty in federal court to income tax evasion charges. Mathis, the fourth NBA referee, busted for converting first-class tickets into cash, then buying coach seats at a lower rate and pocketing the difference. Mathis resigning from the league, as we says. His lawyer, however, says he will try at some point in the future to try and get back in the good graces of the NBA. One injury note, Bobby Fields has been activated by the Cleveland Cavaliers. He's been sidelined with hamstring problems. More after these messages.
Call 1-800-THE-DIME. There are millions of reasons to fly today. Only one that matters to you. At Delta Airlines, it is our pleasure to get you to the place you want to be. Delta Airlines, on top of the world.
Okay, honey, how about this? I'm seeing a cabin.
Are you seeing plumbing?
Imagine a big porch, a stone fireplace, plenty of room for the grandkids.
When you find yourself writing the story of your life, tell it to Jefferson Pilot Financial. We'll help make it happen.
My big painting of dancing bears?
No.
Aw.
You had me till the Bears.
Come on.
Yankee center fielder Bernie Williams checked into Tampa training camp today to try to get ready for the 1998 season. Bernie, who just signed that big $8.25 million contract, says, hey, money aside, time to play ball now.
My main priority now is that we're very happy with the contract situation for this year. At least it's out of my mind now, so I can concentrate on playing and without any more thoughts and hopefully having a great year. I'm talking about the team. Obviously, I want to do well too, but I want to help the team win and go from there.
Trailblazers lead the Knicks by 2 at the half. Back to the Rose Garden after this.
John Lithgow performs the Discover Card Dial-Along song.
An extemporaneous piece.
Provided for your dialing pleasure while you call 1-800-IT-PAYS-2 and apply for your Discover card, the card with a cashback bonus award that always pays you back.
That was a nice surprise.
And that's music to everyone's ears. It pays to Discover. To apply, call 1-800-IT-PAYS-2. Accepted where you see the Novus sign.
Hiya, son. I'm off to work now.
Okay, Dad.
With complete 24-hour service, Geico Auto Insurance starts working on your claim immediately.
Be careful with her.
We'll get you back in your car quickly, so you won't have to rely on alternate transportation. Geico Direct. A 15-minute call could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Dimage, the first digital camera with a move and zoom lens. A 3-foot cable shoots over the crowd's head behind your back. Shoot up a storm, then download only the best into your PC. Yes, Dimage V, the digital camera with a fast break detachable lens, only from the mind of an ultra.
It's another College Hoops doubleheader. LIU visits Monmouth in a Northeast matchup, followed by Xavier at Duquesne in an A-10 battle. Saturday on
You're into the game. Get into the gear. Have you heard about Nothing But Hoops? It's the official catalog of the NBA. You can get NBA Authentics. That's the same stuff players wear. Hey, it might even help your game. Get the coolest stuff from any team, anytime, anywhere. Even WNBA stuff. What more could you ask for? for your free Nothing But Hoops catalog, call 1-800-301-4000. That's 1-800-301-4000. I love this stuff.
Come along, join the biggest stars
as they soar into the night.
We've hit the stage to watch the NBA play.
I love this game.
NBA. I love this game.
We need a demon Saiyan.
I love this game.
I love this game.
Some of our announcers' clothing is furnished by Perry Ellis Menswear.
Halftime from Portland. Knicks trailing the Blazers 46-44. Our halftime scoring summary brought to you by the new Jeep Grand Cherokee 5.9 Limited. From 0 to 60, it's the world's fastest sport utility vehicle. The new Jeep Grand Cherokee 5.9 Limited. Amon Stoudemire, 12 points, just one assist. He's been looking for a shot. Vita Sabonis had 9. Most of those for the free throw line. Isaiah Rodas shot miserably, but he had 8 points. Grant with 6. And Walt Williams had 5. Meanwhile, for the Knicks, Allen Houston, 7 of 10 from the field, 15 points. Charles Oakley, 5 of 7 from the field, 13. Larry Johnson at 8. Chris Dudley, 4 points and 7 rebounds. Hello again, everyone, along with John Andres, Mike Breen on hand. As the Knicks started off well, John, led by 10, shot the ball well, very well in that first quarter. But then in the second quarter, they started to get careless, settled for some shots, and turned the ball over. 7 of their 10 turnovers in that second quarter.
They also didn't get to the foul line enough, Mike. They were outscored by 10 at the line. In fact, only 2 Knicks were to the foul line in the first half. But all in all, I think it was a solid half. They outshot and they out-rebounded the home team. And considering the size, that's pretty good.
Some of the first half highlights, and of course for Portland native Damon Stoudemire, a big part of that. Our halftime highlights brought to you by Jeep Wrangler, the original top-down on- and off-road fun machine, Jeep Wrangler. And Stoudemire, just his second home game in front of the Blazer fans, got off to a good start.
Yes, Damon Stoudemire very anxious to take over a game and do things that he's capable of, and this was one of his beautiful moves of the first half. Stoudemire, 5 out of 10 from the field for his 12 points.
John, there were some old-fashioned shots I know you loved in the first half.
Folks, this is not George Mikan, but it's the best imitation of George Mikan down low. Mike, you know who George Mikan is, right? I don't assume everybody does, though. One of the great players in the history of the league. And at the other end, how about this from Chris Dudley, that former Blazer, showing them also that he's got that soft hook shot.
And do we have a two-handed set shot here?
So you're going to have to wait a long time for that one. But he had 19 minutes in the first half, Dudley, and led everybody in rebounding with 7. And how about the touch? How about that beautiful touch of Allen Houston? And he really led the Knicks with his terrific shooting in the first half.
So the Knicks trailing by 2. Again, need to take the ball hard to the goal and dish out more penetration. That's what Jeff Van Gundy is certainly preaching. You've been watching the Tri-State Jeep and Eagle Halftime Report. There's only one Jeep, and it's only at your Tri-State Jeep and Eagle dealer. Third quarter from the Rose Garden coming up right after this timeout.
In a premier television event, the Discovery Channel reveals the deadly secret world of espionage. The technology and tactics, the tools of a spy.
You might say I'm dressed to kill.
Spy Tech, premiering Monday at 8 Eastern and Pacific. Only on the Discovery Channel.
Warm, snuggly blankets, rocking chairs and lullabies, baby steps, bubble baths, 1,000 games of hide-and-seek, curved balls and broken windows, first loves and broken hearts, newborn baby. A lifetime awaits him in a little gray house on Chestnut Street. For a free guide to help you on the path to homeownership, call the Fannie Mae Foundation. We're showing America a new way home.
Money simple. Enter here. What if you could tap into Citibank right from your PC? Wouldn't it be easy if you could pay bills without writing checks? Or see what you've charged lately without waiting for the bill? Imagine moving money around this quickly and having an expert to answer your questions day or night. Citibank's PC banking puts you in control. It makes money simple. Citibank, the city never sleeps.
The New York Lotto jackpot is now $40 million. Cool.
You know, when I became a fan when they had Mark Jackson, it was the Bomb Squad. Remember that poster? Gerald Wilkins. Just the bomb. When they had Patino, Patrick's running out there, flapping his arms, getting into aerobic shape. And I love the Knicks. I'm from New York. They play tough defense. I like the players, especially Starks, because started from nowhere. He's wrapping groceries, now he's playing ball. So I used to wrap groceries, so maybe I could be a referee. I don't know.
New York Knicks basketball is brought to you in part by Fannie Mae Foundation, showing America a new way home. By Priority Mail from the U.S. Postal Service, we deliver. And by MetLife, get met, it pays.
Halftime in Portland as they get ready for the third quarter. Knicks trailing the Blazers 46-44. Some of the first half numbers. Knicks on the road. Pretty good shooting percentage, John.
Excellent, Mike. Certainly from the field. To shoot 48% is just tremendous. The foul line is where they got outscored by 10. In the rebounding department, the Knicks did very well, considering that this team has beaten Utah in three games off the boards and beaten the Lakers in two wins off the boards.
Five of those 10 offensive rebounds from Chris Dudley as Sabonis knocks it away from Houston off his leg out of bounds. And that's the overall game of Arvydas Sabonis. Knicks said, three turnovers in the first quarter, seven in the second, and quickly get one here to start the third. Sabonis against Dudley. That's a long way to hit a hook shot. O'Neal knocked it loose. That's a good play, smart play by Dudley, making him take it further out.
Sabonis is very frustrated talking to the officials on the way up court, as Dudley has really taken the space away that he wants.
Cannot get it go down the other end, however. He's trailing by two, opening minute. In the third, Grant, poor pass, and he yells at Sabonis. Grant makes a bad pass, yet yells at his teammate for not being in the right place. Oakley, Dudley's tip. This kind of goes out for the Ryder. The Blazers come the other way. Sabonis, more words for Bruce Alexander as he comes up the floor. You know, he had never received a technical foul in his first 2 years. Finally got one a couple of weeks ago. In fact, got two and was ejected. But prior to that, not one technical foul.
Well, he speaks five languages too, Mike, so many times when he's complaining, he might flip into, one of his many varieties.
That's a very good point, as Oakley picks up his third foul on the entry pass. Do you know dirty words in other languages?
No, I don't. But sometimes they have a tone, you know.
Ward had to throw it in, and Allen Houston with good hustle. Knicks quickly come the other way. Knicks have not been able to get going on the break. Only five fast break points. Houston Stoudemire knocks it away. Boy, there was a lot of contact there as Ward drives to the lane. Dudley's tip misses again. O'Neal the rebound.
It was Charlie Ward's first shot attempt.
Stoudemire a little out of control. Ryder bends three. Grant can't save it. No one scored yet in this third quarter. We've played nearly 2 minutes.
Charlie Ward in 15 minutes of the first half didn't take a shot.
Allen Houston had 15 points in that first half. Knicks certainly want to get him back the ball. Ryder's not known for his defense.
Allen has the whole side of the court to work this one out.
Tough shot for Allen Houston. Ryder played him perfectly. Didn't go for the fake. Contested the shot. And Houston still knocked it down. Houston now 8 of 11 from the field. Ryder, that's another three. Isaiah Ryder off the mark, and Dudley's call for a foul. That's going to be his third. So Chris Dudley with three fouls. Ryder, by the way, is now 2 for 14.
Allen Houston with a clear out a moment ago, working on Ryder. Goes left, comes back in, and gets that shot up under a lot of pressure and makes it.
Dudley and Oakley each with three. Terry Cummings, by the way, if you're just joining us, played 4 minutes in that first half. Arrived in Portland about 2 hours before game time. Sabonis misses a three. Oakley, strong rebound in traffic. And we have a loose ball foul. Jermaine O'Neal, and that's typical Charles Oakley. Gets a body on his man, boxes out, and draws the foul.
O'Neal has really been held down tonight. He played 15 minutes of the first half, 1 out of 2 from the field, 2 rebounds. And this young man's been playing terrific basketball lately.
He's shooting to start the second half. That foul on O'Neal, his second. Johnson gets the feed, and a blocking foul called on Grant. Larry Johnson will go to the line again. Grant now has 4 fouls. While we have a moment, we'll tell you about plenty of NBA and NHL action coming your way all this week. First up, it's the Nets. They battle the Sixers in New Jersey. 7:30 tip-off tomorrow on Fox Sports New York. Tuesday, Knicks at the Garden to battle the Warriors. 7:30 on MSG. Wednesday, hockey returns. Islanders and the Stars. 7:30 Fox Sports New York. And on Fox Sports New York 2, the Devils tangle with the Panthers in Florida. Thursday, Mike Richter and the Rangers play the Maple Leafs. 7:30 face-off on MSG2. All coming your way. Johnson misses the first free throw. Johnson now 2 of 7 from the line. Knicks is a team 5 of 10. Second straight game, the Knicks have really struggled from the line. Johnson misses another. And as we mentioned earlier, he's been really shooting free throws well in recent weeks until the last two games. Blazers still have not scored as Sabonis throws it away again. Blazers have not scored in this third quarter. We've played nearly 3.5 minutes of the period. Houston lost it. Trying to give and go with Dudley. Not a smart pass, and it's going to be Nick Ball. Check that Blazer ball.
Well, Allen Houston points it himself. Even had he gotten the ball to Dudley, you know, on the move, having to dribble, it just wouldn't have worked out. So just poor judgment by Allen Houston.
12 Knick turnovers. They're headed for well over that mark of 15, but Jeff Van Gundy wants to keep it, especially on the road. Under 15, actually. Stoudemire, oh, a nice move from Damon Stoudemire.
It just shouldn't be that easy for Stoudemire. I mean, there was no help.
He's got 14. That's the first points of the third for Portland. 3 minutes and 45 seconds without scoring. Houston with a quick jumper. And Allen Houston now with 19.
Allen Houston.
48 apiece. Just over 4 minutes gone by in the third. Houston 9 of 12. Ryder. And a ball tipped in? No, no one touched it. They say Ryder gets the 2 points. Jeff Van Gundy felt O'Neal got a piece of it.
Allen Houston's been eating up Ryder, so Ryder came back and knew he was going to take the shot.
Charlie Ward! And Charlie Ward with his first field goal. He's got 5 assists. Now with 2 points in the game, tied at 50.
Boy, the size advantage that Portland enjoys has meant nothing so far.
Ryder took his eye off it, started to make his move before he secured the basketball. And another turnover for Portland. They now have 11.
Get him out.
Johnson, aggressive move to the basket, puts it in off the glass. Larry Johnson now in double figures with 10.
You know, Michael, we're seeing now with all the talent on this team, they just don't have a good team spirit out there, and certainly not defensively.
They haven't been a bad defensive team this season. Sabonis steps back for the jumper. Oakley grabs another board. Knicks leading by 2. Backdoor, Allen Houston puts it in. A gorgeous feed from Charlie Ward, and a foul. Chance for a 3-point play as the Knicks take a 4-point lead, and Mike Dunleavy wants timeout. Charlie Ward executed perfectly on the back door. 6:41 remaining in the third. Knicks with a 4-point advantage.
The number one selling automobile in America is Toyota Camry. Got it? And Toyota's February inventory clearance is a great time to buy. Get it? With 6,000 new Camrys just delivered, you'll find great Camry deals on a huge selection. Only $249 a month, leases a new Camry and all that comes with it. Or buy now with easy financing. There's a big selection of Corollas. You can't beat their value. Or go Toyota 4Runner. Got it? Get it now. You'll find the deal you want at Toyota's February inventory clearance.
Dilbert for Office Depot.
I've decided to abandon logic and manage by cliches. It won't be easy, but I'll take it one bird at a time. And remember, the customer is always right-handed.
This is actually an improvement.
Here's a real improvement. Office Depot's best catalog ever. Easier to use, easier to read, more products. Call today for your copy and start getting fast, free delivery, guaranteed low prices. Business is crazy, but Office Depot makes sense.
Air Force One. Buy it now on video.
I would like to ask all Americans to pray for the safety of everyone on board Air Force One.
When freedom is held hostage.
I'm the President of the United States.
It's time to take a stand.
My husband will not negotiate.
America's most thrilling adventure is here.
We've got a job to do.
On video, Harrison Ford.
We will never negotiate.
Air Force One. Buy it now on video cassette and DVD.
Knicks lead by four, 6:41 remaining in the third. Terry Cummings played 4 minutes in that first half. Has not seen action yet here in the third quarter, but Jeff Van Gundy knows that Cummings can be a very solid addition to his Knicks team now that Buck Williams is out with the knee surgery.
He's the type of guy who can play the bigger, stronger centers. he can make a shot. He's a pretty good offensive rebounder. At the same time, we all feel the sting of losing Herb. We really do. You know, it's the one thing I said to our guys, I'm really proud of how much they care about each other. And so they, you know, they feel very badly about Herb having to be a part of a trade, as do we.
The thing about Herb Williams, and Cummings is also a quality guy, but Herb Williams not only well-liked, but well-respected. And he was very close with a number of players, including Charlie Ward, probably was Charlie Ward's closest friend on the team. Cummings, a veteran just like Herb Williams, who has leadership abilities, which Herb Williams certainly have. But Cummings still has a good offensive game. He says now he loves to play defense. That's where he prides himself on. And a good rebounder as well. He's a very solid addition. You don't expect to get a player of his caliber in many cases.
Well, the irony, I think, is how his game and personality resembles Buck Williams so much. I refer to his professionalism in every way, including off the court in the locker room.
Knicks continue to shoot horribly from the free throw line. Now 5 of 12. Houston, by the way, on that basket, now with 21 points. He had his 10 games of 20 points or more snapped in Utah. Starts another streak tonight. Now we're still early in the third.
Just watching Sabonis dictate where his teammates should be going and cutting O'Neal. Sabonis came out and said to him, "Who cut?" You know, real basic stuff going on out there. What a range of experience when you look at O'Neal, who's 19 years old, and Sabonis at 33, and all the world experience he's had.
Larry Johnson with a three-pointer. Knicks have not been shooting threes well, just 1 of 7, but Johnson hits that as the Knicks now on a 9-0 run, and they have a 7-point advantage. Blazers looking a little confused offensively right now, as John mentioned. Stoudemire forcing the action. Tough shot from David Stoudemire. Boy, it didn't look like he had much anywhere to go, but found the opening.
Remarkable when you look at the size of him, what he's getting done out there.
That ends the 9-0 run. Just under 5.5 remaining in the third. Charlie Ward, that's a 2. O'Neal the rebound. Three-pointer, in and out. Sabonis can't get it. Houston another rebound. Houston now with 4 boards. Blazers 1 of 10 from three-point range. Oakley. Ryder the rebound. Blazers now shooting 38% from the field. Knicks at 47%. Ball knocked away, but Houston knocks it out of bounds. Still Blazer ball. Ryder gets in Bruce Alexander's face for a moment to complain, felt he was fouled.
You'd have to say the Blazers are seeing defensive intensity like they haven't in quite a while. They haven't been anywhere near that percentage you just mentioned, Mike, in several games.
Knicks trail by 2 at halftime. They now lead by 5, just over 4.5 remaining in the third. Ryder trying to post up. Cato makes the move.
and gets the friendly roll. Kelvin Cato, the rookie now with 6 points. 57-54, a three-point Knick lead. Houston off the screen. Allen Houston. He has absolutely found the stroke again. 11 of 14 from the field, 23 points for Houston.
Get the feeling the Blazers are playing like they don't know anything about Allen Houston. He's just getting open and taking shots and making them.
Well, Dudley set a good screen that time. Ryder didn't do too much of a fight to get over it. Stoudemire. Ryder with a three. Air ball. Ryder is now 3 of 16 as Sabonis called for a foul. Ryder complaining he got hit. When you're 3 of 16, you look for all kinds of reasons. Third foul on Sabonis as Chris Mills comes in for Larry Johnson. Johnson with a big third quarter. 13 points, 4 rebounds for Johnson. Mills back in.
Sabonis leaves. Williams returns.
That was a 14th foul against Portland. Knicks with only 2 here in this third. 3:40 remaining.
Oh, Sabonis is out there. He walked to the bench and he came back out.
Houston gets some contact, knocks it down. Allen Houston having another one of those stretches. He's got 10 of his 25 here in the third quarter, and there's still 3.5 remaining. Remember, he recently had 22 in the third quarter. Ryder is hammered this time, and he'll go to the line for a couple.
I mean, you know, whenever Houston gets a basket, Ryder's going to come down and shoot no matter what. He's matched up against Houston, and he's being outplayed severely.
Chris Dudley is saying that that foul was not on him. They do call it on Dudley. That's his fourth. Dudley saying, yes, Ryder got fouled, but I wasn't the culprit. He's saying it was Charlie Ward who tried to take the foul. Ryder hits the free throw. Terry Cummings will come back in for Dudley. Again, if you're just joining us, Cummings arrived about 2 hours before the game. Met his teammates, chatted with the coaches about some defensive schemes. Let's take a look at the foul again.
It's Dudley behind Sabonis.
It looks like Dudley did hit him.
Well, he was certainly active in the play.
And he hits the free throw. 61-56. Allen Houston open all alone. And Ryder's getting really burned defensively as Houston is on fire here in this third quarter.
I mean, he's playing atrocious defense against Allen Houston.
Ryder's hearing boos again. As we told you, he has not been a fan favorite.
So he's going to shoot right away as soon as he can after his man scores.
3 of 17 from the field. More boos. Cummings. Cato the rebound. Knicks with a 7-point lead. Stoudemire blocked by Charlie Ward. Sabonis down to Cato, and he's fouled by Allen Houston. They're going to call it a 2-shot foul, and we'll have timeout. Allen Houston, 12 of his 27 here in the third quarter. Isaiah Ryder, 3 of 17 from the field, and hearing the boos as the Knicks lead by 7. Pushed back by Cote, makes the pass across the Prince game. Score!
You're watching MSG Network.
We're on over.
How has Black history made an impact in your life?
More than anything, it gave me a sense of pride and a better understanding of who I am. It made me more determined to do something positive with my life.
Some people may say, I'm not African American, so why do I need to learn about Black history?
Because Black history is American history. It's about celebrating American people. That's why everybody should celebrate Black History Month.
We work for a highly funded yet unofficial government agency. Our mission is to monitor extraterrestrial activity on Earth.
Oh, that can't be good.
I knew it. This is an alien, and you guys are from some government agency trying to keep it under wraps.
Nah.
Men in Black.
Playing this month on Direct Ticket, only on Direct TV.
This is where I work. These are my coworkers. Those are my customers. And that's me. Employee number 8. I make baskets.
Just under 2.5 remaining, third quarter in Portland. Knicks now lead the Blazers 63-56. Our Toyota matchup, no contest right now, John.
Oh, it's all Allen Houston, and he has taken Ryder out of the game and totally upset his poise as well. Ryder's just a one-man show out here. Houston's been magnificent.
Houston 6-for-6 in the third quarter.
One of his very tough moves. Ryder thought he had him under control, but he didn't. Same thing there, quick release. Allen getting the ball just right as he comes off the pick. And Ryder totally fell asleep on Allen Houston on that last play. That was embarrassing, and that led to boos. When do you see a player booed for lack of defense? I mean, you never do, but we're hearing it here tonight.
He's certainly been hearing it for the last several weeks, ever since he walked out on the team in that Laker game when he was taken out. He left the building before the game ended, was suspended for a game. Then criticized the city, as we said earlier, as Cato hits the first free throw. So this has been building up. Ryder has had his problems, as we've said.
Meanwhile, he's one of the top scorers in the league, leading this team in scoring over the last 6 games, averaging 26 a game, shooting 53%, but it's fallen in on him tonight.
3 of 17 from the field for Ryder. You mentioned his talent. That's certainly why they put up with his antics that he's had over the years.
The reason he left the court in L.A. is against the Lakers, rather, was because the fans were booing him, as it turned out.
Charlie Ward underneath. Cummings can't handle a pass, and it's picked up by Ryder. Cato underneath. Ball got deflected, a late whistle. Charles Oakley looks in disbelief. They're going to call it on Allen Houston. And Houston picks up his second. So Cato has been very active, goes back to the line. 2:05 remaining here in the third quarter. Cato here off the bench, 8 points and 5 rebounds. As we said, Charlie Ward, probably Herb Williams' closest friend on the team, and that's Charlie Ward's sneaker, with the number 32 written on him in honor of his former teammate, Charles Oakley. Allen Houston did the same. Ward very close to Herb Williams, as we said, as the entire team. And John, I know you've been doing the NBA for a long time, and in my years in the league, you don't find them any better in terms of a person than Herb Williams. And as Ernie Grunfeld said, there will always be a job at the organization when he decides to retire. A lot of people hoping that the 76ers waive him so the Knicks can bring him back, which happened when he was traded to Toronto. Houston off the mark. That's his first miss here on the third.
Well, Herb's had several fine moments on the court lately for the Knicks as well.
Ryder shot off the mark. Brian Grant, good job on the offensive glass. Walt Williams with a 3. Oakley pulls down another strong rebound in traffic. Chris Mills, 3-pointer. That's good. Mills from downtown. The Knicks back up by 6. Knicks just 3 of 9 from 3-point range.
Right from the start of this game, the Knicks' heads were into it, and they have been tough throughout.
Knicks shooting 49%. Blazers just 36%. Strip, Houston on the steal. Bounce pass to Ward. Charlie Ward underneath. And the Knicks go up by 8. That's their largest lead here in the third quarter. Knicks battling back from a 2-point halftime deficit, and with a minute to go in the third, have a 68-60 lead.
Grant's trying to get position down low, and he's wearing Charles Oakley. Cannot get the position he wants.
Way off the mark. Shot clock was winding down, and more boos for Isaiah Ryder, who's 3 for 19. When do you say I don't have it and I stop shooting? Half minute remaining in the third. A strong third quarter for the Knicks. Houston wants to take Ryder again. Lost it. 2 on the shot clock. Ward heats up the 3. And a 24-second violation.
See, Ryder's such a talented player. What he ought to do is go away from the jump shot and start driving the ball.
Start Starks comes in. Oakley sits down. Oakley 13 points, 6 rebounds. Ryder continues to fire away. Fans here behind us yelling at him, play some defense, Ryder. Shot clock is turned off. Ryder seems to be bothered by something on his right hand. Stoudemire with the spin. Starks right on him. Walt Williams the rebound. Put back. Blocked by Cummings. And that will end the third quarter. A strong one for the Knicks, especially defensively. Led by Allen Houston's 12 of his 27. Blazers only score 14 in the period, and the Knicks lead by 8.
Well, my Discover card statement reads like a wish list.
What?
Toys. I like toys. I love pinball machines. This will improve my golf game. It is unbelievable to me how fortunate I've been in my life, and I can't ask for anything more. Discover Card Cash Back Bonus, no competition.
It pays to discover. To apply, call 1-800-IT-PAYS-2. Accepted where you see the nervous sign.
The number one selling automobile in America is Toyota Camry. Got it? And Toyota's February inventory clearance is a great time to buy. Get it? With 6,000 new Camrys just delivered, you'll find great Camry deals on a huge selection. Only $249 a month, leases a new Camry and all that comes with it. Or buy now with easy financing. There's a big selection of Corollas. You can't beat the value. Or go Toyota 4Runner. Got it? Get it now. You'll find the deal you want at Toyota's February inventory clearance.
The New York Lotto jackpot is now $40 million. That's $40 million. Cool.
New York Knicks basketball is brought to you in part by Toyota. Every day. By Discover Card. And by Office Depot. Business is crazy, but Office Depot makes sense.
Notice the high school seniors. Sign up now for your chance to win an MCS Canon Knicks Community Service College Scholarship. All high school seniors with a 75 percentile or higher GPA are eligible if involved in voluntary community service. Now you send a copy of your official transcript, a letter of recommendation from a teacher and a community supervisor, and a written essay on community service describing its importance to you. Call 212-465-6465 for more information. The deadline to submit applications is March the 6th. Fourth quarter set to begin. Isaiah Ryder, 3 of 19 from the field and getting scorched by Allen Houston, will begin the final period on the bench.
He's such a sensitive player. This could have repercussions for the rest of the season if this continues in the fourth quarter for him.
Well, he's had his problems with the fans, and much of it brought on by himself. There's not a lot of sympathy for Isaiah Ryder. Shouting encouragement to his teammate there. I saw him holding his hand. Perhaps injured it. May have something to do with the poor shooting.
You know, when a guy's shooting that poorly too, it's really nice to see him throw a pass once in a while.
Oh, the ball deflected. Excellent defensive play. Turns into a chance for a three-point play for the Blazers. First, Starks made an excellent deflection. And on a broken play, Grant grabs it and gets fouled. Starks the first deflection, and then Williams, smart play, tips it, but Mills couldn't hold on to it and then commits the foul. Grant starting because Rasheed Wallace not playing, out with a hip pointer.
Ironically, Rasheed Wallace was the only player coming in tonight who has started every game for the Trailblazers this season. He's having a terrific year as well.
Starks with the move. Oakley tries to tip it, saves it to Ward. A hustle from Charles Oakley gives the Knicks another possession.
Knicks allowing John Starks to go one-on-one now with a clear out. He draws a double team, gives it up.
Ward kicks it out. Mills on the leader. Chris Mills with a nice adjustment. And the Knicks back up by seven.
Mills has such poise, even in the middle of a move when he can do a number of things. He's always in control of what's coming up next.
7 points for Chris Mills. 1 minute gone by, fourth quarter. Ward, superb defense on David Stoudemire. There was some contact there. Stoudemire wanted a foul, but he lost the ball. 13 turnovers now for Portland. Lehman Stoudemire, by the way, one assist tonight. Starks, that's a two. Way off the mark. Starks now 0 for 7. Walt Williams. Williams, a nice half step. Little layup for the veteran out of Maryland. 70-65. Knicks with a 5-point advantage, just over 90 seconds gone by fourth quarter.
You know, that one assist number, Mike, that you point out is remarkable. This guy who averages 9 a game, and he had that one in the first quarter. That's unbelievable.
Allen Houston knocks it down. Allen Houston continues his torrid shooting. He's got 29 points, and the Knicks back up by 7, and that one got oohs from the crowd.
One of the great shooting performances once again, 14 of 18.
Remember, just recently, Houston had that 34-point game against Cleveland. Ogden. Brunson. Oakley the rebound. And to Starks, one man to beat. Starks. Beautiful move from John Starks, and the Knicks lead by 9.
You know, it's amazing. So many fans here in Portland cheering on these beautiful plays by the Knicks. And I don't think they're Knicks fans, Mike, as much as they are basketball fans. It's quite a contrast here in the style of play.
Stoudemire tied up, gets it to Grant. Grant 7 on the shot clock. And Stoudemire throws it away. David Stoudemire struggling, and you got to give Charlie Ward a tremendous amount of credit. Ward will sit down as Chris Childs comes in. Charlie Ward, 4 points, 8 assists. Oakley sits down as well. Knicks right now have Childs, Starks, and Houston, 3 guards, along with Johnson and Mills. This may be the smallest lineup we've seen on the floor at one time for the Knicks. Johnson, the tallest player out there on the floor. Johnson against Grant. Jumper short. Walt Williams able to bring it in. Childs now with the task of trying to stop the penetration.
He did.
Williams misfires. Grant the offensive rebound and put back. Ryan Grant now with 11.
Well, he's quite an addition to this team, although he hasn't shown that much tonight, but he will grow into a major role.
Starks to Johnson. Johnson across the lane. Blocked, but a foul. Mike Dunleavy can't believe it. But Johnson will go to the free throw line. They call it on Grant, and that's his fifth. Walt Williams says, no, it's my foul. But I don't think they're going to change it. Grant remains with 5 fouls. Allen Houston will sit down. And Larry Johnson to the line. Johnson's played a strong game, 13 points, but he's only 2 of 8 from the free throw line.
Larry Johnson to the line, shooting 2.
It's that one. I want to remind you, for extensive coverage of the national sports scene with an eye toward the hometown team, watch Fox Sports News tonight following the game right here on the MSG Network. Dunleavy calls a 20-second timeout. As the Knicks lead 75-67 with 3.5 gone by here in the fourth quarter. Of course, the Knicks will return home. They have an afternoon game Sunday against Houston. Our next game right here on the MSG Network for Knicks will be P.J. Carlissimo, the Golden State Warriors, coming to town. Donyell Marshall, former UConn star, is playing very well since Sprewell was suspended. Our coverage will begin on MCS Cannon game night, Tuesday at 7 o'clock. Tip off shortly after 7:35. Waiting for the arbitrator has to rule on Sprewell. He has until mid-March to make his decision. We will hear from a lot of the All-Stars who are in New York on what they think about the Latrell Sprewell situation. That'll be on the pregame show. MCS Cannon game night on Tuesday.
Former Trailblazers coach last year, P.J. Carlissimo, was let go by the franchise after the season, now with the Golden State, where all of that negative publicity emanated from. Johnson this time hits both. Bob Whitsitt runs things for the Trailblazers. Also does for the Seattle Seahawks in the NFL. Pretty versatile front office guy. 76-67. Knicks lead by 9. Grant and Oakley. Stripped by Childs. Chris Childs, excellent help on defense. Knicks playing some inspired basketball. After that debacle in Utah, Larry Johnson, the runner, just kind of flipped it up there. Grant the rebound. Ryder. Couple of fakes. Starks knocks it out of bounds. Ryder can't believe, and Ryder got hit with a technical. He punched the basket stanchion.
Here it comes.
Now he's coming after Scott Foster, who teed him up.
He's claiming he did his own thing and nothing to do with the call. He's frustrated with himself. I believe that's what he's saying or trying to communicate.
No, that clearly was not the case. He was upset with the no call. Now he's trying to change it. And still, that's Scott Foster, the young official who hit him with the technical. Childs will go down and shoot the technical free throw.
Chris Childs at the line.
Trying to get his intentions across to the official, but it's too late. But he's just so frustrated. As I said, Mike, the best thing he can do when he gets the ball is throw a pass. But he's not into that.
He has as many assists as field goals as Childs hits it. Knicks have now equaled their largest lead of the game. See, and there's upset with the call, looks at the official right away, and then punches. And that's where Foster hit him with a tee. So now the Blazers will get it out of bounds.
You see the fan behind him expressing feelings of many people here at the arena. At the Rose Garden, which is filled with thorns tonight for Isaiah.
Absolutely. 16 on the shot clock as the inbound. Isaiah Ryder to the goal. And this time draws the foul.
You know, I got to feel sorry for Sabonis.
Just see Ryder playing to the crowd now, perhaps saying, give me a hand.
But Sabonis is dying to play with guys who want to hit him with passes, cut off him, play the game the proper way. And he's playing with a bunch of young guys who are just on a different wavelength.
That foul on Johnson is first. Ryder 7 of 7 from the free throw line, but as you see, horrible from the field. The Blazers, that's what's keeping them in the game right now. Unbelievable free throw shooting, 92%. They're 24 of 26.
Question is, can they play the defense necessary to contain the Knicks the rest of the way?
Starks gets it to Larry Johnson. Johnson, the short jumper. Excellent decision from John Starks, and the Knicks back up by 10. Johnson now with 17. Ryder, 3 for 20. Starks down the other end, manages to control it. And the Knicks will set it up. Just over 7 minutes remaining here in the fourth. They lead by 10. Childs, that's a 2. Sabonis the rebound. 79-69. Grant blocking foul called on Chris Mills. Mills picks up. Lead number 4. Yes, that's 4 on Mills. For the Knicks, just their second team foul. Just under 7 minutes remaining, fourth quarter, a 10-point Knick lead.
Ship your package in 2 days with FedEx. You run into 7 different price zones.
Ship your package in 2 days with UPS. And you'll run into 7 different price zones.
Ship your package in 2 to 3 days with Priority Mail. And there's just 1 price zone.
So, what's your priority? Priority Mail from the U.S. Postal Service.
Some people think the Pentium 2 is the fastest processor in the world. Not quite. The chip inside every new Power Macintosh G3 is up to twice as fast.
With the Nissan Maxima's powerful V6, Ward's Auto World call it one of the 10 best engines of 98. And with standard features like air conditioning, power locks and windows, and comfortable seating for five, IntelliChoice call it a best overall value in its class. Take advantage of this limited time offer, and you can call the Maxima the best thing of all, yours. Right now, get the Nissan Maxima with $1,500 cash back and 5.9% APR for up to 60 months. Ends March 2nd.
Just under 7 minutes remaining, fourth quarter in Portland. Knicks lead the Blazers by 10. Time for our MCS Cannon game summary. Knicks playing well on the road, bouncing back from the horrible loss in Utah to the Jazz. The shooting strong from the field, not the free throw line. And the defense on Isaiah Ryder, 3 of 20. Allen Houston, an unbelievable third quarter.
Go back last year to a third quarter when the Knicks were 2 for 17 here in Portland, with a remarkable spin downward. And then in the fourth quarter, they only had scored 5 points. Fourth quarter, they came back in the game and won it in overtime.
Now that was one of the more exciting regular season games of the season. Sabonis tells Williams to come over and get it. Williams, an open jumper, cannot connect. And Childs a rebound. Knicks lead by 10, just over 6.5 remaining in the fourth. Oakley, Mills the offensive board.
Get the ball into John Starks' hands now.
Starks feed to Larry Johnson. Ball deflected. Childs tries to save it but can't. And the Knicks turn it over. Their 14th turnover. Just their first here in this fourth quarter. ...79-69, a 10-point lead. We're approaching the midway point of the fourth. Excellent penetration from Stoudemire, and Sabonis now in double figures. The lead is 8.
Oakley picked up Sabonis moments ago, and it seems like it's so rare when they do get the big man the ball.
Plenty of time remaining. Starks. Oakley. Johnson the offensive rebound. Knicks very strong in the offensive glass tonight. Johnson with the spin, kicks it out to Mills. Childs on the pull-up. Chris Childs knocks down a big shot. And the Knicks back up by 10 with just under 5.5 to play.
Knicks are playing and communicating so well together throughout this game.
81-71. Stoudemire, the feed to Chris. Blocked by Oakley, but a foul. Charles Oakley will pick up his fourth. And Grant will shoot two. Grant now 11 points. He's 3 for 3 from the line. You see Allen Houston back in, and Mills sits down. Mills very quietly effective. 7 points, 5 rebounds.
Brian Grant, certainly the most important offseason acquisition for this franchise, who last year featured Clifford Robinson, who left to go to Phoenix as a free agent, and of course, Chris Dudley. This young man came along at the right time for his career. Got a ton of money to come here to Portland.
Grant hits the free throws. Blazers continue their terrific free throw shooting, 26 of 28. An 8-point lead, just over 5 minutes remaining.
Knicks have not had spells, dry spells.
Houston falls down on probably a wet spot.
Seems that every time they come over half court, most two-thirds or more, 70% of the time they're scoring. They're getting something positive done.
Stoudemire. What a move from Stoudemire to get the shot off. Childs upset. He felt he got pushed off. But Childs will pick up another foul. Third on Childs. Stoudemire to the line. You don't think he has anywhere to go.
See him lean in.
Look at the right hand, though. Initially, there was a bit of a push-off. Yes. Childs did foul him on the shot.
I was talking to somebody today about his talents. As I mentioned earlier, talking about Stoudemire, who's so good at setting picks, I said it reminds me so much of Stockton, who was so physical. John Stockton right. of Utah, we saw him the other night. He'll go into a big man, sink that shoulder or arm into him, and make him withdraw. And that's just what this guy does, too.
He misses another free throw. Ball tipped, and Starks comes away with it. Stoudemire, 2 of 6. He's the only guy on the team to miss free throws. And he's a good free throw shooter, 81% in his career. Just over 4.5 remaining. Oakley. Starks with a three. Grant the rebound.
Barnes had a tough night from the field, 1 for 9.
Stoudemire again draws the foul. Childs once again argues the call. Chris Childs with 4 fouls.
Never seen a player in such pain when the foul is called on.
Stoudemire makes you make those faces. Now, there's not a lot of contact, but he's got his hand on him when he's shooting the ball. Stoudemire, 17 points, 5 rebounds, 2 assists. He's 3 of 7 from the line. The rest of the team is 24 for 24.
No, you right.
81-75. Lead has been cut to 6 and still plenty of time. Just under 4.5 remaining. Fans trying to spur on their Blazers.
Blazers.
Stoudemire whacking Houston as he tries to get free. Houston, quick turnaround shot. That's good. And a foul. Allen Houston calling for the ball with a chance for a 3-point play, and he's got 31.
That's what you want. When you get a mismatch like that, you got to get the ball to the man who favors the situation. You can see Allen Houston on a switch now, getting the position. And no question, when he turns around, it's nothing but his eyes, his hands, and the rim.
Houston hits the free throw. Knicks back up by 9. Allen Houston, his second 30-point game of the season. With 4 minutes remaining, a 9-point Knick lead. On the bench, very vocal and active, trying to cheer their team on. Stoudemire, what a shot! 5'10", Tamen Stoudemire answers back.
Amazing shot. But they have to dig in at this end, and they can't seem to contain the Knicks.
Ryder back on Houston. Now they switch again. Knicks want to get it to Houston with Stoudemire guarding him. And Houston makes the adjustment and puts it in.
How can they allow that to happen? No help coming Stoudemire's way.
Sabonis was late getting over there. And Houston has tied his season high with 34 points, and a disgusted Mike Dunleavy calls timeout. 3:22 remaining. Houston 16 of 20 from the field. Knicks by 9.
The Knicks are at the Garden to battle the Warriors after MCS Cannon game night, Tuesday night on.
I'm about to unleash the biblical plague.
For Special Agent Sean Archer.
He wants people dead.
There's only one way to catch a killer.
State-of-the-art morphogenetic template.
You want to take his face and mine?
You've got to become him. From the director of Broken Arrow, John Travolta, Nicolas Cage.
What do you say we trade back?
Face Off.
Plan B. Let's just kill each other.
Playing this month on DirecTicket, only on DirecTV.
Today's flight is a special one.
Meet the first class passenger.
Makes the Manson family look like the Partridge family.
Of Con Air.
Where are you going with my plane?
We're going to Disneyland.
Now, it may be their party.
Yeehaw!
But someone.
He's a U.S. Ranger, highly decorated.
Is about to crash in. From Jerry Bruckheimer, producer of The Rock.
It's on your mind, hillbilly.
Goodbye.
Con Air.
Buckle up.
Playing this month on DirecTicket, only on DirecTV.
Two remaining, fourth quarter in Portland. Knicks now lead by 9. Thanks to Allen Houston, has tied his season high with 34, his career high that with the Pistons 38. He's 16 of 20 from the field. Johnny's only taken two free throws. Normally he scores when he has big nights a lot from the line, but 16 of 20, the 16 field goals made, that's a career high.
Well, instinctively in the mismatch favoring him, he goes down low and he gets the basketball.
And here no help is Izzy Stoudemire now defending him on the switch. Sabonis kind of backing away.
I don't understand that.
He's only got three fouls.
He's got 34 points in 34 minutes of play.
Phenomenal shooting from Allen Houston. In the second half, he's 9 of 10 from the field. He had 15 points at halftime and has only missed one shot since intermission.
At the other end, Portland Trailblazers not sharing the basketball. How about this? Their top assist man for Portland is Isaiah Ryder with three. I don't even remember one of them. The guy just seemed to shoot the ball every time. New York has four people with more assists, led by Chris Childs, who now has eight.
Williams stripped by Oakley, but a foul. Oakley just reaching in, and Charles Oakley now has five personals.
Well, Jeff Van Gundy has to be very proud of the way this team has responded after that performance the other night in Utah. When asked about reviewing the game tape, did you throw it away? He said no. But we don't want to totally forget about it, but we don't want to make a big point about it. It's a little of each, and he got his team in the proper frame of mind, which they showed when the ball was tipped off tonight. They have been consistent. They've been into it. They've been sharing the ball. They've been playing the game to the great pleasure of the fans here who enjoy basketball.
Kelvin Cato comes in. Grant sits down. Williams hits both free throws. It's a 7-point Nick lead. 3:15 remaining. Childs, Starks, Houston. Three guards along with Johnson, who couldn't handle a pass. Ryder the other way. Runs into Childs. Offensive foul. Chris Childs draws the charge. Mike Dunleavy is furious. And Ryder can't believe it either. It's been one of those nights.
Well, Ryder's getting support from the fans here. I don't think there's any question about the call. Let's take another look at it now.
From that angle, it looks like Childs was in pretty good position.
Childs was run into, clearly.
And Ryder called for a foul on Starks down the other end. Dunleavy is still screaming at New Hollins. Ryder is yelling. Now, don't forget, Ryder picked up a technical foul earlier, so one more and he's automatically ejected. It's only the third team foul, John, so the Knicks will take it out of bounds with 2:54 remaining.
Ryder didn't try and divert around the defender. He just went square straight into him.
Giles setting it up. Oakley to Larry Johnson. Johnson on a follow-in. It's good. Tough shot from Larry Johnson. And the Knicks lead 88-79 with 2:35 remaining.
Well, I must say, Sabonis, as talented as he is a very passive defender.
The pass to Cato. Cato with the slam. 88-81. Knicks by 7. 2:18 left. Knicks need to get it over the half court mark. Starks does so. Pretty feed to Johnson. Left handed. He blows the layup. Blazers come the other way. Stoudemire a little out of control. Double team. Lost it. Williams picks it up. A lot of contact on that play. Williams lobs it. A steal by Larry Johnson.
One bad judgment after the next by the home team.
88-81. 7-point lead. Under 2 minutes remaining. Knicks trying to close out this three-game trip with an impressive win. 8 on the shot clock.
Knicks spreading the floor out.
And a foul call on Ryder. Ryder got right up on him. Again, that's the new rule. Player facing the basket with the ball. You can't put your arm on him until he puts the ball on the floor.
This is no secret.
And you watch him come out here. Watch, Houston will receive the ball. Ryder yelling at the official.
I mean, at this point in the season, he's going to argue that call like it's a new rule or something. I mean, this is dumb.
This Scott Foster, as Ryder picks up his fourth foul. That's only the 14th foul, so the Knicks will inbound again. A lot of fans now heading for the exits. This game's not over yet, though. There's 1:38 remaining. The Knicks lead is 7. This is a very important possession for the Knicks right now.
Amazing thing is the Trailblazers come in here tonight oozing with confidence. They lost to Seattle Wednesday. Just got Nate McMillan back, played a terrific game at Seattle, but then they had 5 straight wins. Here's another look at Isaiah Ryder's chart. Looks like he's walking too, getting away with a walk. There's Childs. Kaboom.
Yeah, that looks like an excellent call. Ryder initiating the contact. Knicks get the new 24. Starts the feed to Johnson, left-handed. And the Knicks go up by 9 with 1.5 remaining. Beautiful pass from John Starks.
Mike Dunleavy, he's got a lot to talk about on the subject of defense with his team. It's a very poor defensive performance.
Sabonis. Cato, Sabonis with a 3. Jeff Van Gundy screaming to stay home, but yelling at Charles Oakley not to give up the 3. That's a huge play. 90-84. 107 remaining.
Knicks have to milk the 24 now.
Starks with 8 on the shot clock. Again feeds Johnson. Johnson blocked, but a foul.
It's amazing how poorly Portland plays the pick and roll play, because the man rolling to the basket seems to have a free pass.
4th foul on Sabonis. Let's take a look.
You can see Johnson roll. Who's picking him up? Who's picking him up? He gets all the momentum in the world till the end of the play, and Sabonis just is over there. But there's no aggressiveness in the direction of the cutter.
Johnson hits the free throw. Now 22 points for Larry Johnson. He started off poorly from the line, but has now found the mark. Another strong all-around game for Larry Johnson. Hits a pair. And the Knicks lead is 8. Timeout, Blazers. 58 seconds remaining, 4th quarter in Portland. Knicks with an 8-point lead.
This year, the Old Farmer's Almanac predicts 50 inches of rain. Is your rent-a-car company ready for that?
Not exactly!
And 40 inches of sleet and snow, are they ready for that?
Not exactly!
Now, Hertz introduces a more comfortable way to return your car. The new Hertz Return Center, where you're protected from the weather all the way to the terminal. Does your company do that?
Not exactly!
58 seconds remaining in the 4th. Knicks lead 92-84. Time for our co-classic play of the day. Last year when the Knicks played here at the Rose Garden, John.
An amazing game. The Knicks 2-for-17 in the 3rd quarter. 5 points. They come back. They force the game into overtime. The closing seconds of the game. Kenny Anderson handles the ball. You can see the clock ticking away. The Knicks up by 1. Anderson tries to get the ball inside. It's mishandled in a pass. The Knicks recover. And after that crazy 3rd quarter, when they came out and took in charge of the game in the 4th quarter and the overtime, they walk out of here with a win. And you're looking at a happy Knicks team and a dejected coach P.J. Carlissimo, and that was a Coke Classic play.
That was a very emotional win, as is this one would be, because the Knicks coming off maybe their worst performance of the season, getting completely dominated by the Jazz in Utah, face a Blazer team that had been playing well, had won 6 in a row here at the Rose Garden, and Allen Houston coming up huge. We'll give Mike Dunleavy some problems. Houston with 34 points. 19 of the 34 in the second half. He's 9 of 10 from the field in the second half. Williams to Sabonis. telling Williams, come back and get it. Well, Williams hits the jumper.
When the man sets a pick, you're going to get a free shot. That's amazing. It took him all night long to make a play like that with Sabonis.
92-86, Johnson to Houston, who wisely will take some time off the clock. And they foul Larry Johnson as Cato commits the foul. Johnson missed his first four free throws tonight, but has hit six of his last eight.
A moment like this, you say, let's see, what is Portland going to present three-point shooting-wise? And you look at what they've done tonight, and you find out they're 2-for-18 three-point range.
Johnson hitting some big free throws down the stretch. Larry Johnson, for the 13th time this season, John, has hit the 20-point mark. Last year, he did it only seven times all year. He's got now, for the game, 25 points. Knicks lead by 8, 41 seconds remaining. Sabonis, Cato fouled, and Cato will shoot a couple. Jeff Van Gundy holding his breath on that one going in. Allen Houston commits his third. Cato's a 71% free throw shooter. There's 36.7 seconds remaining. Knicks leading 94-86, an 8-point lead.
Cato, a first-round draft pick by Dallas, number 15 in the draft last spring. And draft rights were acquired by Portland of his in exchange for rights to the Blazers' first-round pick, the 18th pick, which was Chris Ansley. Cato, a terrific shot blocker, and has had many outstanding performances this year, but he's kind of been lost tonight, as has his entire team.
Sabonis goes to the bench, Augment in for defensive purposes. 94-87. Augment knocks it away. Ball tipped by Walt Williams. Stoudemire tried to save it, but he was out of bounds. 30.2 seconds remain. 94-87, and Jeff Van Gundy wants to call timeout.
But Stoudemire replacing the drink he knocked over there, the little cup.
Jeff Van Gundy a little disheveled. He's coached a hard game. His team's played a hard game. They lead by 7.
Adolphus Busch went to Germany every summer looking at different breweries, and he wrote a series of letters back to his son. September the 20th, 1897. I would advise that we buy the finest growths of barley as soon as we can. We cannot make fine malt from inferior barley, and we cannot make fine beer from inferior malt.
The ultimate Derek Jeter dream date. First you call a girl. Tell her that you're preparing a perfect candlelight dinner for her. I throw in some R&B. I can't cook, so I order some food. Tell them to give me the works
and put it on my Discover card.
Splash on a little cologne. Throw on your apron and the Discover card cash back bonus. It's the icing on the cake. What else would she want to do but to watch highlights of us winning the World Series in 1996?
It pays to discover. To apply, call 1-800-IT-PAYS-2. Accepted where you see the Novus sign.
Remember, when you're having good times with good friends, drink responsibly, because friends know when to say when. A reminder from your friends at Budweiser. Knicks fans in attendance at the Rose Garden as they lead 94-87, a 7-point lead with 30.2 seconds remaining. And here's where Starks had it poked away. Watch Damon Stoudemire make the dive. He was out of bounds, but he spilled a little popcorn. Trying to replace
him. As a well-bred young man. He probably knows everybody here, so he'd get yelled at if he didn't do that.
Perhaps he's a neat freak. A Felix Unger type.
That's right. Well, meanwhile, the Knicks against the Blazers over the years coming in tonight, 33-39. This has always been a very tough team for the Knicks to play against.
Blazers, no doubt, they don't come up with a steal foul right away, as Augment does on Starks with 26.5 seconds remaining. Knicks with a 7-point lead. Starks has not been to the line. Jeff Van Gundy reaching a milestone tonight if the Knicks hold on, as he will have his 100th career win if the Knicks emerge victorious. Three impressive names on that list, John.
Yes, certainly, and we are reminded once again to wish Red Holzman our best. Red fighting a health battle. But he's tough, and he'll win, Mike.
He's always in our thoughts and prayers. Starks goes to the line for the first time.
95-87. If the Knicks hold on and win, they will be 15-11 without Patrick Ewing, since he went out with the injury. They were 15-11 with Ewing in the lineup this season.
I think this is one of the outstanding, one of the number of outstanding wins the Knicks have had this year. When you look back at Indiana, Seattle, really, really, because coming in tonight after that game against Utah, you know that the foundation was shaken the other night, but they have bounced back beautifully.
If you believe it's not just where you're going in life, it's how you get there. Get to the National Chrysler and Plymouth event. Get $1,500 cash back on Chrysler Cirrus or low 1.9% APR for up to 60 months. Get $1,000 cash back with Chrysler Sebring Coupe or lease America's favorite convertible Chrysler Sebring for just $299 a month. Get to the National Chrysler and Plymouth event only at your Chrysler and Plymouth dealer.
Dimage, the first digital camera with a move and zoom lens. A 3-foot cable shoots over the crowd's head, behind your back. Shoot up a storm, then download only the best into your PC. Yes, Dimage V, the digital camera with a fast break detachable lens, only from the mind of an ultra.
The Infiniti i30 and Lexus ES300 offer luxury, comfort, and performance. The i30 also offers a power sunroof, leather-appointed interior, custom Bose audio system, and the i30 is priced $3,300 less than a comparably equipped ES300. And they make you pay for the floor mats. Lease the Infiniti i30 for $399 a month for 39 months with an initial payment of $1,249. Infiniti. Own one and you'll understand.
26.5 seconds remaining here in Portland. Knicks with a 9-point lead as they try and finish up the road trip with an impressive road win. Next game on the MSG Network will be Tuesday. Knicks, of course, play Sunday afternoon against the Rockets at the Garden. That game on NBC Sports. And the Golden State Warriors, first time Knicks facing them. MCS Cannon game night kicks off our coverage at 7. Tip-off shortly after 7:35. As P.J. Carlissimo comes back to his old stomping grounds. Blazers close to a 5-second count, and there it is. Jeff Van Gundy called it about a second before Alexander. And they don't get it in time. So a 5-second violation, a costly turnover.
Mike Dunleavy, the last 4 years, Milwaukee Bucks, last year as GM, years before that GM and coach. This is the first time since 91-92 he's really coaching, only coaching when he was with the Lakers.
Starks is fouled by Stoudemire with 22.3 seconds remaining. As the Knicks look like they're on the verge of a very impressive win on the road. Blazers just 39% shooting from the field. The Knicks defense extremely strong. Starks did not shoot well, 1 of 9, but his defense certainly a big part of this game.
Well, that was certainly offset by Larry Johnson and, of course, Allen Houston's remarkable shooting tonight, and Oakley, who got off to such a good start and gave the Knicks a lot of offensive spirit.
Terry Cummings played 7 minutes, flew across the country. Introduced, hello, my name is Terry Cummings. I'm your new teammate. Got some brief instruction from Jeff Van Gundy and Brendan Malone. Now he gets to fly back to the East Coast again.
I'm always amazed how when a player comes like that so suddenly that the uniform fits. How do they do that?
Starks hits the free throw. This is the largest lead of the game for the Knicks, an 11-point advantage in the final seconds. Stoudemire flips it in. 22 for Stoudemire, but only 2 assists. And the Knicks, with the shot clock turned off, will try and dribble it out. Portland apparently will not foul. Here in the final seconds. And there's the buzzer. Knicks go 2-1 on this 3-game road trip and one of their better road victories of the season. And Jeff Van Gundy smiling as Stoudemire's team goes down to defeat. Their 6-game home winning streak comes to an end.
Big win, excuse me, Mike. Big win, big confidence builder, and gets that memory of Salt Lake City way in the background.
100th career victory for Jeff Van Gundy.
Knicks are now 5-1 since the All-Star break. And as you say, John, perhaps most importantly, that Utah game is forgotten in their minds right now. They put it behind them. They bounce back very nicely from that debacle. And even trainer Mike Saunders celebrating. So the final score from the Rose Garden in Portland, the Knicks 98 and the Blazers 89. Plenty more to come from Portland when we return after this timeout.